Hello.
Knocking Pokemon and not use my data.
Check it. There's usually a breath over here.
Real?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, check this out. So, I got an Abra, and I'm like, sweet. So I got a bunch of Abras.
Thought it was making it better.
Well, right? So now I got a Kadabra, and I'm like, all right, cool, 460 Kadabra. This is going to be kosher when I upgrade it.
Four dogs.
I got like a 719 fucking Alakazam. I was like, why do the Pokemon gods hate me?
Hey.
Yeah, I evolved a Zubat, was like 187, it went to 801. I was like, you gotta be kidding me.
Damn.
I was like, I'm getting shaded on right now.
Sure,
right?
I thought it worked right.
Everybody ready to go?
Sure. So enthused.
Yo.
Turn mine up a little.
You can't hear it. You can't. The mics aren't on yet.
I can say yo into a mic.
What?
Can I get a little more? Can I get a little more snare in my
headphones?
I go
by Alex on the show, by the way. So don't get confused when somebody else calls him Kevin, because that's also Kevin.
Kevin.
I am confused. Hey. Oh, now I'm ready. Goody.
Mm-hmm. So excited.
Damn, that's lit right there.
Taking care of my.
I don't know why, but I really, really want. Like, since I started playing this damn game, I wanted a King Glitch so fucking bad.
In between
I didn't know why. And then I watched Pokemon and I was like, oh, I understand why.
I caught so many dope water Pokemon when I was in Portland.
Oh,
it's
not like out of the ordinary
really
one.
It's because it's marshy
like,
up there. Apparently you can get a Gyarados in a day if you go to San Francisco.
It's fucking awesome.
All the
400 motherfucking Magikarp coins. I was like, you gotta be kidding me.
It's
I was like, yeah, I got it. Tight. And then I'm like looking at like, how much should I evolve it to a Gyarados? 400. I was like, no, I give up already.
Colors are hard.
Going together like Skittles and cake. And then online mode, they go together like Skittles and fish.
Yes.
Alright, 10 seconds.
And it was a movement, you know?
My filter situation here. Hold.
The Dirty Dowdy Podcast is for an adult audience. The Dirty Dowdy Podcast may contain material that may be unsuitable for sensitive ears. Listener discretion is advised.
Well, we're back.
All right.
It's the Dirty Daddy Podcast here at the Longbox.FM studios, brought to you, of course, by Riley's Brewing.
Thank you, Riley.
And they came in strong this week. We got the Gralifornia, or California. California. The milk stout and the pineapple mango. Sancha?
Yeah.
So there's a lot of brews going around the room. This is going to be an interesting night. And I do believe there's a little bit of relief coming with tonight with some of us around the room. It's nice to get back to fun, right?
Yeah. We're going to need this.
So I'm sure that anyone who's been listening to, the earlier week's worth of stuff is going to be enjoying what's going on tonight. We got quite a show lined up, a very special fun game, but I do want to start off with very simple and easy. Contact us, 4920450. You can hit us up in the YouTube chat room. You can follow us along on Twitter as Vanna is doing her live tweeting? I don't know.
It's tweeting.
I'm not a
I like Twitter painting.
I'm not a
Twitter painting.
Twitter painting. There we go. And of course, Skype once Cottie gets in here, cuz it's a Wednesday, so of course she's not here. But she'll be able to man the Skype. We'll get you up on the screen and you can chat with our guests tonight. We do have the band in Amoret. Right now we got 0.5% of the band. Point 0.5? Sorry.
5.
Common Core. Yeah. My bad.
We're half American.
Yeah.
It's an approximation, so it's absolutely correct.
Yeah, well, we'll be hearing from you guys, Christine and CJ, and maybe one more here in a little bit.
Who's to say?
Well, get on the phone and tell them get here. You quit your job and just shoot over here.
We could order a pizza.
Please quit your day job.
No,
you get here.
That's why. Wait, what? Kenneth, get on the pizza.
One pig, dog.
Hey, Mountain Mike's has a coupon right now.
Oh, there we go. We got something going.
They'll deliver warm piss right to our house.
Make sure to hit up the website, longbox.fm, as we keep growing. There's blogs now up on there. Van, I know, is going to be coming up soon with that. We do have another intern, Pete, shadowing us tonight, and I chatted with a second intern, Pete, and a third intern, Pete. So we're going to be peeting it out.
Yeah.
They don't get names, not for a while. And we're doing lots of planning for future events, like something in December that will be talked about at some point. And of course there's all the podcasts that are the Longbox FM family there, the you know, That Movie Podcast, Firefly Podcast, all of them. You can download, listen to all of their things. So with that being said, how are you guys doing?
Good.
You excited?
Tired.
Fine.
Have you learned anything?
Learned
do you
plenty.
Need to?
I think we do.
Okay.
Now it's time to showcase what we have learned in the last week.
Kevin.
So that music is so Pavlonian. I want to get naked to it. I don't know why.
What?
Huh?
Careful, you got Kenneth sitting right next to you.
Enough with my inner monologue.
Go ahead, Kevin.
I learned that when the rest of California is on fire, it creates a nice little heat insulator for us, and for a day or two, we get to enjoy some crisp, cool 104 degree weather.
Yum.
Pleasant.
That was the cool days.
That was a nice cool day for us.
You know they talk about Russians. You always see in the movies the "I was born in it" and pounding their chest, and they're in the snow shirtless or something.
Yeah.
How do we not have the equivalent for heat? Like, we could just be wearing a hoodie and multiple layers and sweat and just be like, well, I'm used to the heat. That's just what we do.
This isn't going to translate, I'm sure, on camera, and maybe the lighting off to catch you guys later. This is my driving tan. I don't know if you guys can see the difference between these two.
On
a color palette, like if you were to buy a paint
at
the
store. It also looks like one is stronger than the other.
Well, the right one, obviously. It's the one I steer with. Come on. I got to move the whole car. This is like 9 shades of color difference on like a pink color palette.
So is that like 10 shades of Kevin?
I like it.
There it is.
Well, going from that disgust,
that Pavlonian-ness again.
We haven't had you in a while, but Slot, you're back in studio.
I am.
And I know you may not have learned it in the last week, but you've shared the story a couple times, and I feel that you need to share this.
Oh, God, not the whole thing. He needs a whole segment on how to tour Mexico.
Yeah.
Can you give us a short, just a piece?
Nothing short in that story.
Nothing good in it.
I'll just give you the highlight, and I learned that my dad doesn't know how to pick out a hooker. Yeah.
Gangbang rookie.
And he learned that if he takes too much Adderall, his dick doesn't work, and he ends up just paying a hooker for talk therapy. So.
Did you have some good father-son bonding time?
It was.
I ask if she even spoke English?
No.
She's just nodding. Uh-huh.
She's looking at her watch the whole time.
She told him to come back the next day, and she gave him a good discount.
And then she wasn't there. Right.
At the end of it, did he pay?
No tip.
No tip.
From who?
Somehow he still got A's.
Neither.
Neither tips?
No.
Oh, no.
Alex.
I learned absolutely nothing.
Good for you.
That's what I learned this week, that I learned absolutely nothing.
God, you suck terribly. Vanna, save me here.
I learned that if I wanted to get in a fight about off-the-grid stuff and politics, I should probably pick a fight with a homeless person instead of Kevin.
I was the calm, collective one.
That's saying something.
But on the lighter side, I learned that all my biggest fans I meet in bathrooms. So I like going to the bathroom for compliments after my sets. It's like my favorite thing to do. Sometimes I don't even have to go. I just need to pick me up.
So you're like a Republican.
How dare you?
That's in an airport, all right? Not at a comedy venue.
Actually, I believe...
Or Famous Dave's.
Thank you, San Jose Improv. I love you.
I totally believe her on this, because after every show, Kenneth just sits in the bathroom. Just waiting.
Just waiting.
That's just waiting.
One day.
In the shower?
That's different.
That's kind of rapey. Just a little rapey, dude. Just...
I learned that all of you think I'm going to come to the studio with a large caliber weapon and dance around your corpses while on air.
I wonder why we would think that.
Yeah.
You articulate, that's the most articulate you've ever been in your entire life.
Yeah, because he's practiced.
I'm actually even more scared because you said it calmly.
Yeah, for real.
We
you didn't yell it loudly.
That's just the beer talking.
We were talking just pre-show, and my view for Kenneth, when Fierce Creatures was on last week, they were actually concerned about him after the show. On the 360, if you look at the footage at the end of the show, they were actually like concerned, and are you okay, man? They really pick on you. And he's like, yeah, they do. I took over for a retard, and this is what I do.
Pretty much.
But I think at one point, Kenneth is just going to come in here and massacre all of us and then sit and make it his show the rest of the night.
Yeah. Massacre you.
Will he have clothes on when he does it?
I don't want to go that deep with him.
I'm down.
He'll be wearing Dowdy's skin.
Yeah. There we
just
go.
His face.
As a sweater.
Will you talk like Dowdy when you do it? No.
I don't know if anybody can talk like Dowdy, but Dowdy. I don't know if that's good or bad.
Well, thanks for the transition. What I learned this week.
There you go.
I learned two things. It doesn't matter how old you are or how professional, quote unquote, you try to be. When you're behaving badly on radio, your mom will come over and tell you and your friends that you need to stop and go into the corner.
Sorry, Mrs. Dowdy.
Monday was one hell of a show.
Oh, man, what a fire.
Tune in every Monday night, 7 p.m., Longbox.FM. The kick where we kick each other mentally.
Yep.
It is exhausting.
Spiritually.
It is only a safe space in the regards that we've all kind of quietly agreed we won't punch each other in the head. And that's only because it hasn't happened yet.
I feel like I got to pull a contract out for that.
If you wish.
Yeah. Also, one other learning thing. I've learned that I can't stick to my guns when it comes to Pokemon. I've said that I will only play the game if I can sit in my bed and capture something. I will not move 10 feet to one side to capture anything.
So where'd you go to pick it up?
My son grabbed my phone. Apparently, his stepdad has taught him all about it. So he made me and Cotty walk in the heat, middle of the day, up and down the block, searching. And then he also knows every Pokemon. He's five. He knows every Pokemon now.
Yeah.
So, and he was disappointed that Daddy didn't have a, I don't know, Charizard or Retard or something. I don't know which one it is, but Daddy didn't have it. But Stepdaddy has three, so I was like, oh, God damn it. This is not the pissing contest I'm getting into. For our band, did you guys learn anything?
Jared.
She singled you out.
I learned that you can get some really cool Pokemon at Woodward Park today.
There we go.
Oh, yeah? What can you get? What did you get?
I got a Raichu today. That was pretty rad.
That's Raichu's.
I got a...
Not
pretty. Sing.
If you go to the bathrooms at Woodward Park, you can also get a Kentard.
Dude, I actually learned that you can have your dick looked at in the bathroom at Famous Dave's, too. That was...
A glory hole is on.
Very interesting experience.
That was more interesting than what you said before.
Yeah, let's
go
to that one.
Yeah, that's a different thing to learn.
Yeah, you don't have to use this in anything.
That needs to be explored.
CJ, representing Amoret, tell us about your dick being looked at Famous Dave's.
That's not
CJ.
I'm Jared.
Jared. Sorry.
CJ's not here yet.
Oh, I'm bad at this, by the way.
He's very bad.
I have a shy bladder, so I was like, all right. Walked in the bathroom, dude was standing there at the mirror. I'm like, okay, this is cool. So I went to the urinal, you know, I'm doing my thing, stand there, got my courage up. Dude walks right next to me, like, no room. There's a whole nother thing next to me. And
that's
like,
what it was like.
Your microphone's cut off. That's what it was like.
There was another urinal, like, 3 feet to the left, but he went to the one in the middle. You never go to the middle one.
Yeah.
Man.
Yeah, what the fuck?
It's a social contract.
He went to the middle one, man, and I'm, like, standing there. I'm like, okay, whatever, that's fine. So I'm, like, you know, thinking about, like, rain and waterfalls.
Did he pee first?
No, but he was looking first, that's for sure.
Oh.
I caught this dude like straight up just like goggling, and I was like, no way. And I was like, hey, do you mind not looking at my dick? And he just like went like and just kind of like looked away, and I walked out. I couldn't do it anymore.
Can I give you some advice? And I've learned this firsthand.
You gotta stare back.
you gotta stare him in the eyes.
Kind of, no.
I didn't want to get cruised at Famous Dave's by a dude.
When a guy's doing the awkward in the bubble, in an open urinal area where he can go anywhere, but he has to sidle up to you.
You have to assert dominance.
All you gotta do is just turn your head just very casually, look at him, just go, nice dick. I guarantee he stops midstream and moves to the next urinal over.
Or he punches you in the face.
This guy probably would have been like,
yours too, man.
Well, the good
thing—that's
when—that's
when you start peeing and then turn your entire body his direction.
Yeah, just pee on.
Sorry, I can't control my body emotions.
Slowly though, so I'm he having... gets to choose.
This sounds like a horrible train wreck for anybody that actually like follows this advice.
You got to go like the sprinklers at a school. They, you know, just a. And just, you know, pinch it off and just squirt at him as he's running.
If
right?
someone ever tells you nice dick, the correct response is prove it.
And on that note, tonight's show, we're going to be giving away tickets to see Westfield Massacre. It's a show put on by the Entourage. It's Monday, August 8th at Fulton 55. We got a bunch of tickets to give away. We're going to be doing that throughout the night. We also got, I thought because of the band Amoret coming in, I thought it would be a really good game to play. I was hoping we'd get all the band in there, or at least three, and that's what we're hoping for come 8 o'clock-ish.
We're hoping
to have three-fourths.
We got the DJ voice off. So we're going to be throwing down. And now, Christine, yeah. you're on the show. And funny little quick story about getting you on the show. You're at New Rock 104. You work there in the whole studios.
I do.
And I do now officially kind of a little bit. And so I was looking at my phone. And I was like, oh, Amoret, that'd be a good one to get in. So I look through and I'm like, oh, Christine, okay. Yeah, I'll friend request her, send a message. Hey, would you like to be on the show? And then I looked at the picture and I went, oh, and then I looked through the glass window where you were working and went, oh, hey, that's you.
Yeah, I love being able to sit right there because I can stare at everyone while they're doing their show. Go just stare them down.
Let's not talk about any of the no inside because I know I get a little retarded in the booth. So
you make some interesting faces. The hands.
Oh, I got to hear this.
Out
come on.
There.
He does spirit hands.
Yeah. I mean,
he's got jazz fingers.
He really, I could see that. He really tries. We're proud of him.
I get animated, even for something like, hey, you just heard this song, go to this event, this is the next thing. But I'll do the body movement of like running a mile.
He really
kinda
tries.
Like Kermit the Frog.
Wait, be wacky. Let's play along too, man.
But the thing is, I could be doing this. I'm just all, so you're listening to New Rock 104.1. Oh, super cool, but I have to move. That's just my thing.
Holy fuck. That was
the Magic Dragons! Damn it. Never pull the curtain back.
You don't want to see behind the curtain.
Well, maybe we'll hear more about that. We'll hear
unless
about
you're
you guys.
In the bathroom.
Your band. We'll hear the whole entire EP throughout the night.
Yeah, you will.
Damn right.
Aggressive.
Challenge accepted. We're going to be taking a break. We're going to come back with Alex hitting up the clambake that he came up all by himself.
Yay. Nope. Yeah. Nope. I will not take credit for this clambake except for the speaking part. Chris Dowdy selected the stories and all stories. And
yeah,
I'm just the one saying them.
Nope.
I don't believe him.
Nope. He's a liar. We'll find out when we come back.
Way better than these ones.
I say we vote whether or not he's telling the truth.
Nope.
I think it's the truth because I see Lindsay Lohan and that does not have Alex written on it. Alex
there's
is
the
faster than that.
All right, we'll be right back to the Dirty Daddy Podcast here on Longbox.fm.
I like her so pre-lifetime.
I go, I'll make sure to hit this.
Yeah, well.
That you're listening to?
Yeah.
She had so much promise, you know?
So here, and
that
now,
was like her
the other thing is
point
I build these to have a long time. You heard that I was starting
she
to
has
music
a redeeming
up.
Point.
Yes, she has.
I don't need it to go all the
way. She was like the first redhead
month,
that I was like,
go ahead and just hit play.
I'm attracted to redheads.
Fire
I just thought she was really talented as an actress at the time.
At this point, you could go back to your slideshow, but
she
should
have
but then I saw George and it was awkward.
Well.
30 seconds. So yeah, it's one of our just quick pass-throughs. And this is a long-term. There's a reason for it.
Hi, my name is Lindsay, and I'm searching for love.
I want to do music because I know people need my music. People need Kanye West albums.
My real apology to her will not come in the form of words.
When people say that I'm not like an airhead and things like that, it's not true at all.
All the stupid things celebrities do, it's the Celebrity Clambake.
Oh, I'm glad we finally got a story that's going to involve one of the voices in that intro. This is the Dirty Daddy Podcast here back on Longbox.fm, brought to you, of course, and as always, by Riley's Brewing.
Cheers.
Thank you, Riley. Yeah.
Kenneth, why? Why are you always so sad when it comes to that?
Because he's
sad
sober.
Or am I just calm?
Dude, ever since you dumped a 55-gallon bottle of jizz out of your nuts, you've been very, very
tight. That's not a bottle. That's a jug at that point.
No, that's a drum.
Alex, go ahead. Give me your first story.
He didn't lose the weight either.
Still called him fat.
Couldn't help it. 55 gallons. That shit weighs a lot. We can start off with the celebrity news, and only celebrity news, because somebody doesn't know how to look on websites very well. His name is, I'm not going to say his name, Chris Dowdy.
Dick.
Ozzy Osbourne is in the news. He's been battling sex addiction, and that's what nearly destroyed his marriage earlier this year.
What?
When Ozzy and Sharon Osbourne split up back in May, she said it was because he was having an affair with his hairstylist, Michelle Puh.
What?
P-U-G-H.
P-U-G-H-N?
I don't know.
What is that?
Now a rep for Black Sabbath Rocker says it was more about his addiction to sex and nothing at all romantic. Rep told people, Ozzy is sorry if Miss Puh took their sexual relationship out of context.
Ugh, she's white.
He would like to apologize to the other women he has been having sexual relationships with as well. Puh said that she felt like Ozzy was courting her, even called it the greatest love of my life.
Please.
Oh, gosh.
She looks that like her last
worst
name.
Pun worthy. Ozzy.
I'll retweet it.
Wait, what was the picture?
Do I
picture?
Get like a soundboard over here?
No.
With
no. Okay. Just you be patient.
No.
Don't get ahead of yourself.
Pa is suing Kelly Osbourne. For
I'm not there yet.
Oh, okay. I didn't
Shut
know.
Your mouth.
See,
I'm
she
doing
wants
celebrity
the news.
I'm going to let. Fine.
I don't. I'm just.
You're going to write
juicy.
It next time, all right? You're going to write it next time. Ozzy is now getting therapy, according to his rep, and he and Sharon say they have been working things out to save their 33-year marriage. Ozzy Osbourne's mistress, Michelle Puh, just dropped a bombshell lawsuit on Kelly Osbourne, in which she admits to a 3-year affair with the rock star, but denies she abused him. Puh's pissed over several tweets that Kelly fired off after Ozzy's secret affair went public. If you recall, Kelly blasted Puh, a hairstylist, saying, anyone looking for cheap, chunky lowlights, a blowout, and a blow job, call phone number. Oh, gosh, that's great.
So, wait, she's calling out her dad's
wait,
dick
put
lover?
Put her phone number on there?
No, on Twitter, yeah. But
oh,
obviously, it's
Kelly
probably
Osbourne.
Been redacted.
That's some down shit.
Yeah. She also accused Puh of manipulating Ozzy, saying, my father is almost 70. Ever heard of elder abuse? Puh
from
says
sex?
She was slut-shamed, bullied, and harassed.
I don't
in
even
her lawsuit.
Think he thinks he was abused.
Filed in L.A. He might have liked it. I think that's called masochism.
So she's robbing the grave?
Shit. Filed in L.A. County Superior Court, Puh claims the relationship was no fling, that Ozzy made advances and turned their friendship into a romantic situation in 2013. She claimed they secretly dated until May of 2016. Puh says Osbourne's accusations
God damn it.
That she committed elder abuse is not only wrong, but defamatory and caused her all sorts of problems. Now she's emotionally damaged and lost business as a celebrity stylist.
I wonder if she ever bit the head off of that bat.
Oh, God.
I can see Kenneth riding. So.
Ozzy and Sharon did not break up due to infidelity. It was their arguments involving financial issues and control.
Oh, my God. You were so uninterested in the story, aren't you?
He's more interested in Puh than he is
yeah,
in the story.
Yeah, I've had more fun just saying Puh to yeah. get the response. All right, so we go from Puh and Ozzy to Phaedra Parks.
Who?
She's standing up for the rapper who got busted for threatening to blow up her office building and believes he was racially profiled by someone in her office building. Phaedra told TMZ she considers Drama a good friend. Do you have a picture of the guy? Oh, is that the guy?
Yeah, it's Tupac Light.
No, is that Drama?
I guess that's Drama.
Yeah, that's Drama.
Do you you name yourself Drama?
That's his name, yes. That's his name.
Drama Bomb.
It's his rap name.
No.
She considers Drama a good friend, knew he was going to be coming to her office last week to drop off his new CD. The Real Housewife star says, things really started going south when Drama went to the wrong floor of the building. According to Phaedra, Drama demanded to see her, and when the receptionist asked him to leave, because it wasn't Phaedra's office, he refused, and she called security. That's where things got really weird.
Huh?
her.
He Dramas? Was just trying to tell them that his mixtape was the bomb, and they misunderstood him.
Do you want to take this over?
She gets the mixtape.
Vanna, calm down. Comete.
This spoke there. To Drama's mommer, mother, who says her son told the guard, "I have a bomb CD it's about to blow up." Literally, like saying it's a good album and it's going to be well received.
I know.
The security followed up by asking if he had anything else about to blow up. And and Drama replied, "I got that bomb-ass CD in the car," referring to the package full of CDs in his vehicle. I'm guessing the trunk. Moments later, cops descended on the building and evacuated the place. Phaedra thinks whoever called the police just saw a guy in a white t-shirt and baggy jeans with gold teeth and assumed the worst. She admits Drama had a poor choice of words. Phrasing is very important. But says that it's just the way he speaks. Plus, he thought he was having an innocent conversation about his music. Drama was booked for making terroristic threats and being held and is being held without bail. Phaedra says she spoke to him on Tuesday and is referring him to her criminal attorney.
Talk about drama.
Oh, God. Oh, drama. You're really into this, aren't
you? If I didn't get it, you're not getting it.
Next one.
An LAPD cop, falsely accused of racism and brutality, is being attacked by the LA City Agency for exposing the truth and defending himself. And now the city wants a big chunk of his retirement.
That'll teach him.
It's a slap to the face to anyone who believes in that blue lives matter. The LA Ethics Commission is gunning for recently retired LAPD Sergeant Jim Parker, trying to force him to pay a $10,000 fine for leaking audio over to TMZ. Audio proving he did not profile a black woman engaged in lewd public conduct with her boyfriend. You'll recall Django Unchained actress Danielle Watts, who is black, obviously, was in a car with her white boyfriend near CBS Studios in the San Fernando Valley back in September of 2014. People in nearby offices called the cops and complained they were having sex in the car. Sergeant Parker responded, and when Watts refused to hand over her ID and then walked away, he cuffed her and placed her under arrest. Watts' boyfriend went on Facebook rant, and God only knows how that ends, claiming Sergeant Parker showed prejudice, aggression because of her color, and cuffed her so tight that she was bleeding. The LAPD did not come out and defend Parker. He was getting skewered in the media, labeled a racist cop, and then he released the audio over to TMZ of the encounter.
Wait a minute. So he released the audio proving that he didn't do it?
Proving that he wasn't a racist cop.
Okay.
He was just a cop. Which shows Watts was not only the aggressor, but falsely accused him of racism and threatened to get her publicist involved. Oh, gosh.
Oh, well, in the LA world.
I'm guessing she said,
"She's a bitch.
Do you know who I am? Do you know who I am?" Oh, my God.
That's what
the Ethics Commission met on Monday and is pressuring Sergeant Parker, who has acknowledged he gave TMZ the audio, to admit wrongdoing by leaking a police tape. The commission lawyers, who was extremely aggressive at the hearing, tried cutting a deal, admit guilty, and paid $2,500. Otherwise, the commission would gun for the retired cop's checkbook to the tune of $10,000.
Okay, so wait a minute. The cop gets accused of something, gets in some major shit because of it, goes ahead and retires. Proof goes out from him that he didn't do something wrong.
He put out the proof before he retired.
Okay, but now they're mad that he put out proof.
Yeah.
And so they're coming after him. So, didn't do anything wrong. And he's, Kevin, hold on to that for Monday.
No, you explained everything.
It's pretty straightforward, yeah.
That, yeah.
Stupid.
You either get it or you don't.
I'm going to body cam myself forever. It'll be a boring one. You'll see my ceiling in my room a lot.
Yeah, so, but the funny thing is that Watts and her boyfriend put no contest to disturbing the peace. They had been charged with lewd conduct. If you're going to have sex in a car, I mean, you do it, like, out in the middle of nowhere, right? I mean, come on.
Or at least on top of it so no one's obstructed.
Oh, yeah, so they can just see everything, right?
Yeah,
you got to give them the show.
It's only indecent if you're ugly.
Who's had sex in a car?
In a car?
How did you have sex in a car?
Kenneth,
was
I'm
it
not,
a van?
I'm
no, we, in a car, not with a car.
He said you're fat. You're a fat man banging a gas tank.
No, I didn't say he was having sex with the car.
I
that
said
was
that
Kevin
part.
Said
yeah,
that.
Specifically me.
That's a thing.
I mean,
strange addiction. This dude was having sex with cars.
I remember hearing about that. Yeah, he was making out with.
I remember that.
He tried to get married to his car, right?
Yeah, he did.
Like the gas? tank?
The exhaust.
Yeah, the exhaust.
Like, and then Muffler's he met this other dude who was into it, and then he raped that other dude's car in the hotel room.
Wait, in the hotel room?
Well, they were in the hotel room.
How did they get the car in the hotel room?
He went out to the other guy's car and like had sex with it while that guy was sleeping in his hotel room.
Wow.
He raped that other guy's car.
Would that even bother you, like, the next day? Like, god damn, now I need to wash this thing.
As long as you don't squirt underneath the handle, I'm good.
Yeah, what would that be the equivalent on a woman? Like,
yeah,
the
how
wrist?
How would you even get to the exhaust?
Oh, for a woman, no, it's all bad. Just all bad.
When you want to do something, don't think about it, or else you're just going to hurt yourself.
That's definitely the moral.
Does he do it after driving for 30 minutes?
Probably not.
Or does he drive around the block and then stop?
I don't know. I don't
warm,
stop.
Not too hot.
Just stop.
Are you just driving around just the block, pulling one slowly, looking for the right car to take advantage of?
Dick shift.
You look for the one that somebody turned off just a little bit ago so it's still warm.
I wonder if he got pegged by his
one
car.
Totally cruising. Or are you a car kind of?
A car on the street with low self-esteem.
Speaking of low self-esteem.
So that's a 93 Honda Civic.
We're going to stop right there. Speaking of low self-esteem, we've got Lindsay Lohan back in the news. She's
still alive?
Not an irresponsible beer guzzly chimney snoking. Dowdy, this is horrible. She is not an irresponsible beer guzzling chimney smoking pregnant woman. She was just, well, lying, according to her mom. Dina Lohan tells TMZ her daughter was an emotional wreck after fleeing from fiancé Igor Tarabazov.
Igor.
Igor. He's a billionaire Russian dude.
Pronounced
of course.
Igor. Yeah, yeah. Well, no, sorry. Let me rephrase
it. Igor.
He's the son of a billionaire Russian dude. As we reported, the two were in such a heated argument, the London cops came and eventually kicked the door in. Dina says Lindsay was trying to get revenge on Igor, whom she accused of cavorting with the Russian chick. He's Russian, go figure. Then she claimed she was pregnant. Oh gosh, that never works. Things got complicated.
Well, I did with Kenneth.
Nope. Nope.
Sometimes it works.
Things got complicated when these pics surfaced showing her smoking, drinking, and certainly looking like she might be pregnant. Do you have those pictures up, Chris?
There you go.
You're going to make a scene.
No, again. No. She just was drinking beer and put on weight. That's not.
No, that's just a beer belly. I know. I have one. Compared.
Yeah.
That's the beer pooch.
She's got smooth titties, gentlemen. Smooth
titties.
Smooth titties.
Like two IPAs deep belly. That's normal.
That's
like two IPAs an hour.
So how many IPAs has Kenneth got?
Like a keg.
30 IPAs.
That's a couple flights.
Dina now says Lindsay was distraught and just overreacted like woman. She's not pregnant and wants some time away from Igor, but it's not done with him, apparently. We're told Lindsay is still engaged and plans on getting back with him.
It'll work out.
All this shit for nothing.
Look, this is good. This is the tail end of her. We'll one day have to move on from Lindsay, so.
Yeah.
Next story.
There's a new bar in L.A. that guides people to the bathroom with more than the traditional men's or women's sign.
Oh, I can't.
The guide is one person with two identities. Can you put up the picture of that? Oh, gosh.
You can go to the Wheaties Jenner.
But is this or
the Vanity Fair Jenner?
Are there urinals in the women's restroom? That's what
I don't know, but this is their door going in.
Yeah, you can go to the Olympic gold medalist.
Nickel Bar in West L.A. greets gents with the famous Bruce Jenner Wheaties pick and ladies with the big Caitlyn Jenner Vanity Fair reveal. You're
get
looking at both doors
both.
In the pick. By the way, it's not an LGBT bar. So
this is clearly taking advantage, right?
This is just a good sense of humor.
Yeah, that's
it's a litmus test.
It's making fun of something.
In L.A. of all places.
If I was Caitlyn, I would go to both.
Just walk through the divider.
Walk in the middle. Hit your head.
It's like platform.
I think someone would
quarters.
Be happy about
you
that.
You pay enough money, you're magical like
I
that.
Would go into
guaranteed.
The women's bathroom, unzip and pull out my penis, drill a hole in the wall, and then pee through into the urinal in the men's bathroom.
Are you drilling with your penis?
That's a lot of effort when you got to pee, man.
Okay, yeah, we're going to stop right there. America's Got Talent viewers just witnessed a truly scary moment when one contestant accidentally shot her husband in the throat
with a
flaming arrow.
Awesome!
Wait. Oh, so contestants Amber and Ryan, a sideshow duo, have made their mark on the show performing dangerous stunts. Tuesday's stunt was supposed to end with Amber hitting a target in Ryan's mouth.
Pause.
With the arrow.
Time out.
But her aim.
Time out.
What a role reversal.
Time out.
It was a little off.
We have the video.
All right.
Oh, okay. Yes.
Ooh, I can't wait.
Put that up.
Oh, god damn it.
Buffering.
God damn it.
Student,
we almost have the video.
Close all your red tube links first.
Oh, gosh.
Yeah, no.
That's okay. The target.
I bet he can
this
beat
is definitely
like
a roll reversal.
Here's the flaming arrow that may or may not hit the target.
This is way better than Hunger
Games. Oh, fuck. Oh, fuck.
Hit him just under the target.
Just, like the jugular kind of thing?
Oh, yeah, right in the middle of the throat. Like,
she went full arrow on him.
You could die from that.
Oh,
right?
Yeah, no. Oh, yeah, you could. Absolutely. Okay.
I think the only
reason... Yeah, her aim was a little off. almost only counts in horseshoes and hand grenades, not in flaming crossbows.
what the fuck?
Our America's Got Talent sources say Ryan's fine. He was just shaking up a bit after the mishap. That's the risk you take when you do it live. Oh, gosh, that's horrible. All right. And
same with this show. There's some flaming
arrows
going in. So, Chris,
how old are you now?
Yeah. I am 20. Nah, I can't pull that off anymore. 36.
You're 36. So you're a year older than MTV, which just turned 35. And to celebrate the special occasion, they gave out free ink for fans. Do you have a picture of some of that? Oh, gosh.
Wow. They have no idea what that means either.
It's great, dude. They're celebrating 35 years of MTV with 15 years of music.
Hashtag no regrets.
What does the M in MTV stand for? Though?
Anyone who wanted a free MTV tattoo could go into shops in LA and New York City, pick from the different logos, and get it tatted anywhere on their body. Some options included the vintage Yo MTV Raps logo and the classic leopard print MTV.
I want a print.
One fan, John Dillingham, told
Daly.
Us it only took about an hour to score his lifelong reminder of a better time, you know, when music television actually played music videos.
I heard they're making a new MTV channel called MTV Classic where they just go back to what they used to do.
You know
God, that'd be so much better than the bullshit
you mean,
that's on there
like
now.
MTV? Like
yeah, like actual music television.
You know,
yeah.
I heard somewhere someone was referencing Korn and Linkin Park and just like
sentence.
Metal and whatever.
All right, it's time for a break.
And talking about the last time that I got to enjoy a metal or a hard rock band was when Carson Daly was on the TRL. And when that show died, that was the end of metal. I was like, what?
Wow.
What?
TRL.
You put Carson Daly
what
in
the
same
fuck?
Title with metal? Nope. Nope.
Nope.
Nope.
Yeah, I remember in 1998, Limp Bizkit was at the top of the charts. And I'm like, I'm going to go stab my ears.
Well, it's like Kid Rock was on there, too.
Let's, yeah, he was number two. I'm just like, what the hell happened to this
like
planet?
That Blur album cover with the pencil in the ear.
Yes.
It's like that magic trick from Batman.
Exactly.
Dark Knight, yeah.
I was ahead of the curve.
All right, tell you what.
Sideways.
We're going to take a break. Reload on our Riley's Brew and all that fun stuff.
Yep.
When we come back, we've got the band Amoret in studio. And I'm going to talk to Christine and make sure she says no more things about my wacky flailing arm man. And we'll get more music.
His name for his penis.
That's not flailing.
No, mine doesn't even inflate.
That's failing.
That's it's like all right. Free Pokemon out there.
It's the Dirty Dowdy
Magikarp of penises.
It's a Dirty Dowdy podcast here on Longbox Life, and we'll be right back.
Don't feel bad, you're not wrong.
did you guys hear what I said about? I said if you're Pokemon fans out there, he's got the Magikarp of penises.
But if it ever levels up, Carp's Carp.
No,
it won't.
But does it actually say Carp?
So now, before I go back, this is has to do with the editing. So when I go and edit, it'll go out. I can take everything out, and
very rarely
some breaks get slid right back into.
I think,
that. It's almost seamless. I don't.
We advertise them.
Like,
but I think we've had
photo
six
or change shit up.
Yeah, like.
Why did I sit here doing my thoughts?
That's right.
I like the buns.
Sushi. Have you been to Pokeland yet?
Oh, that place is delicious.
Pokeland.
Yeah.
It's over on Champlain and Grand, right next to
the reason I like to do that is I don't want to lose.
And it's just like a bowl full
it's
of
like Chipotle,
like sushi.
But sushi.
Yeah, it's like sushi and Chipotle made babies, and they're like, hey. Yeah. The small bowl.
You should take her.
The small bowl. You get three proteins, so you can do like salmon and squid.
Well, again,
and,
it has to do with the protein.
Yeah.
So
whatever.
Or
and if you get the large bowl, you get like two more protein.
Five proteins.
Five proteins.
And you get like an amount of beans.
Protein.
You get
yeah,
like
you get
everything.
Can
like all the everything
you
get in the sushi is clean.
Anyway.
I can cut
so
a whole
like
section out.
So like, and
I don't know. It had cilantro and it had jalapenos on top. But it had like spicy crab.
Is Jason out? Is he done?
Probably. Because we're going to be playing the game.
We're
going to
be the game first?
No.
No,
I doubt it.
All right, here we go, guys.
We still got time to bail, too.
So maybe you're listening to Longbox and you've checked out a few of the shows, you're listening to the music, you're having a good time, you're thinking, man, I'd like to do that. You can. We have the Open Mic Podcast. We do this every other Tuesday here in the Longbox.fm studios. We bring in anyone who wants to do a podcast or has a podcast. You get full use of our gear, our video, everything. You get our audience, you get airtime, you get to go play and have your fun. It's an open mic for podcasters. If you've never done a podcast and you wanted to try, we'll set you up. We'll get you going. Just find us. Go to our Facebook page. It's Facebook, and just search the Open Mic Podcast. It has all the lists of dates that are open that you can sign up for, get on the show. Just tell us what you want to talk about, what you want to do, and we'll help you structure it, get it put together, and you will be live here in the Longbox.fm studios doing the Open Mic Podcast. It goes on every other Tuesday night at 7 o'clock here in Longbox.fm.
Longbox.fm.
Hi, this is Al Pacino, and when I am taking a shit, I listen to the Dirty Dowdy Podcast.
It's the Dirty Dowdy Podcast.
Does anyone else hear Wes Borland, like Limp Bizkit? That's a Limp Bizkit song, right?
I have no idea. It can't be. I like it. I think we need to bring back two things to the show. We need to bring back the promo, the I Listen to the Dirty Dive podcast, and we need to bring back the list of big name A celebrities that we had come in a couple times, like Al Pacino and all those other people.
Well, Christopher Walken's here every so often. Yeah.
Definitely Tom Arnold. And Tom Arnold.
Bernie Sanders is a regular.
He's a regular on the show.
We had Donald Trump once, but it didn't turn out well.
We're not good enough for him. Yeah, he lost that debate.
It's the Dirty Daddy Podcast back here on Longbox.fm, brought to you, as always, Rally's Brewing.
Cheers.
So, to our band, we got to take the focus to the band. So we still have 2/5 of 1/3 of a ninth. It is Christine and Jared, and we will be getting possibly...
We'll be getting CJ here in like a second.
Okay. Well, we're hoping. Two, CJ, get your one. Shit here.
Yeah.
We need to get the important questions in first to get to know the band. For anyone who doesn't know Amoret... And it starts off with this. How long have you guys been a band?
Since as long as my rims still be spinning, dog.
Interesting. What's your inspiration?
The musical version of the Diary of Anne Frank, Vampire Hunter.
Oh, that's a unique way to come. Okay. The name Amoret came from what? What inspiration there?
Again, the Diary of Anne Frank. Vampire Hunter, the musical version, the sequel.
The sequel?
I'm learning a lot.
Last question for the band here. Where do you see yourselves in 5 years?
Leading the rally against political evil. Join the RAPE.
Aww. No. Oh man, you're a dick.
Where's the trigger warning?
we
need that right now.
That's just more metal.
Wrong one. Damn it, sound boy.
That just caused the trigger.
No, actually, perfect timing, because we now have last member another Ramsey.
Yes.
Whoop. Oh, there we go.
Wait, yeah, I'm here. I'm officially here. What's up, guys?
What's up, man? Where's the pizza at?
Oh, yeah, the other guy.
He's bringing warm piz? Or is it going to be cold piz by the time he gets here?
Hashtag warm piz.
I'll reheat. I'll eat reheated
probably
piz.
Probably going to be gone by the time he gets here.
Hashtag cold piz. He's going to eat all the piz.
All right, now let's make it real here.
Piz delish.
For the band, Amoret.
Yes.
You Actually, honestly, because this is important for where I'm going. Where? How long have you guys actually been together performing, recording and all that? Like from inception to the band to right now?
We've been playing together for 5 years now. I mean, this has kind of been like something I've wanted to do for 7, and then it was like officially a full band 5 years ago.
Okay. Now, you guys are getting a lot of love. As far as
we have been, we don't know what happened. We don't know what we did to deserve it.
So no one cared about you. Then all of a sudden you're like a thing.
Exactly. It's like,
how does that feel? Cause I've never been there.
It feels like the third act of like a movie where someone gets popular in high school, but it was all like a prank. So we're waiting for someone to be like, ah, surprise. Like we don't give a shit.
We're waiting to get something like something.
So far it's been good.
Waiting for something from Carrie.
Exactly. Exactly.
Damn, man.
The pig's blood's going to fall on you.
Craig, go get a beer.
I think this show might be.
This show is presented by Riley's Brewing.
Oh my goodness.
Gotta be drinking one of these.
You have to drink this.
Phenomenal. So
I'm definitely going to get a beer.
You don't even have to be unemployed to drink 7 of them.
Actually, you know what? We'll have Kenneth. Why don't you go get our guest a beer? Because you're unimportant.
Why don't I?
Yeah, be a good beer bitch. Question for you guys.
Yes.
Do you guys feel like... Now, we had Fierce Creatures in last week. Yeah. And Fierce Creatures was definitely one of those bands that was huge. I would say 3 years ago, not to knock them in any sense here.
Right.
3 years ago was kind of like... They were one of the big... I would put Strange Vine in there as well. Mm-hmm. The indie, downtown, Fresno, like the... Those are the bands that everyone references and knows. Who gives a shit about going and seeing local music? By the way, you should. and now that they've kind of, you know, they just did another show here for the first time in 2 years. And they kind of just do their own thing. We'll see them in another 2 years or something like that.
Probably.
Do you think Amoret is kind of sliding in? Do you get the feel like you guys are sliding in as that new band that is the darlings of Fresno?
I mean, I would hope so. That would be nice.
That'd be tight.
It would be really cool. I would love that. I know you're always your biggest critic sometimes. Like, I don't look at us now and be like, wow, we are what Fierce Creature was 2 years ago. We are what, I don't know, fucking Flight 409 was 10 years ago. Is that still a relevant thing? No, not at all.
I'll take it.
The Big Game Studios.
Did I just, like, date myself?
Damn, Big Game. All the time. Good time.
I know, we haven't been playing at the Belmont lately, so I don't know if we're doing that.
The exit? The exit.
I would love Richards. To kind of like on your 5 year question, I would love to look back 5 years from now and have someone be like, oh, like you guys were totally up there with them. It's definitely something to strive to. And I think like you mentioned downtown, like that's something we've been really trying to make a part of our image. We live down there. Like we're always hanging out down there.
Our music video. I
gave you $3 the other day.
Mm. Yeah, that's my other gig where I sit out and I accept money in front of your station.
it's a good gig.
It's steady income. It's nice.
And non-taxable.
Stiff competition
exactly.
in Fresno.
You can't track it.
as far as a future planning go, like, so the album was just released back in June.
Yes.
A four-song EP, yeah. Glory Days, right?
Yep.
Chicka-chicka. It's on the screen there. I'll get on
I'm
the
like
screen.
I'm like trying
screen.
To... Oh, okay.
Yeah, there's multiple cameras here. I'm NSAing the shit out of this entire show.
Sick.
So up on the screen there.
I can turn my phone back on there.
Oh, lit.
Yes. Yes.
I wish we had a Coors Banquet to make everyone like pose with right now.
You know, I had a couple of those in the fridge.
Who was that in the picture?
That is CJ's mom.
Really?
Yeah. It was the 70s. It was a better time. You could get away with being a baby drinking back then. You know?
Yeah, it's frowned upon now.
Yeah, it's more monitored and people are stopping you and shit.
It's like,
so.
Loosen up, people. Let your babies get drunk. God.
So, CPS? So like, recently we got married and so a lot of old pictures started surfacing.
Oh, you and CJ?
Yeah. We did that. We did a commitment thing.
We were trying to keep it private, but I guess it's out there now.
So, a lot of old pictures were like coming up, and she found that and she sent it to us. She's like, "This is such a funny picture, right?" And I was like freaking out because I didn't know what to do for our Glory Days cover. And I was like, "That's the picture. I don't care." Someone sent us like graphic design stuff, and I was like, "Thanks for working, but no, I'm going to use this picture of my mother-in-law drinking a Coors Banquet as a baby."
Yeah.
You know, I like it. That's cool.
I've been working on some ideas here for this podcast and promoting ourselves through CD version. And I have a picture that's very similar. I don't have it right now. I wish I could get this. But it was Kevin as a little kid.
Oh, yeah.
In diapers, genius. Smoking. And I was going to call it Glory Holes. But
oh my god!
You guys have totally stolen our thunder, and we can't do that anymore.
You know, we have a reputation for copying other people now, so
I don't want that.
You have my consent to use that photo, by the way. By all means, take it.
The shade is real lately.
I was in a diaper, standing on a stool. I think I was like a year and a half old, or maybe 2 years old, somewhere like 5'10", 5'11".
That is amazing. That's going to be our next EP right there.
If you can find it before I do, take it.
All right.
That's a fun challenge.
Just look up Smoking Baby.
Smoking Baby. There's got to be other pictures.
Yeah, it's that two-year-old in the Philippines or something.
Yeah, with the...
The one that weighed 80 pounds, and then he stopped smoking and drinking, and like, look, he's skinny now. What made a difference?
What? He gave it up?
Come on.
Quitter.
Got a job. Quitter. Got his hair back.
Nah, see, that's... Oh, I can't go down this road. By the way, if you want to ask questions to our band tonight, Amoret, or to anyone, like Kevin and why he was smoking at 2 years old, call us up, 492-0450. We will chat with you. You can ask questions to the band. So, following up... I was talking about what I've been listening to with your band. I really love the song that we played coming into the break there, Home. I called, and I hate doing this. I hate talking to bands and saying what they sound like, because I remember being in a band and being told what you sound like. And sometimes you get something like, you sound like Tool. Oh, well, yeah, cool, yay! No, I don't, but thanks that somebody likes that. Or you get like compared to like, no, you guys are definitely like just like Nickelback. And you're like...
Just thinking that. That's crazy.
People actually like Nickelback.
Yeah, I know. Those are sad people.
Cool.
They should
let
be
me
removed.
Just set myself on fucking fire and give up altogether.
I totally left my leather wristband at home tonight.
Man, Jesus Christ.
That comment.
Dude, look at this photograph, though.
But I compared to churches.
Yes.
The one with the V. The
Traverses.
Traverses. And you guys actually seem to actually like that.
Yes. I love churches. That is a real thing.
What comparisons have you guys gotten?
Well, I was talking earlier. The weirdest one had to be Neon Trees. But sometimes...
Remember when we saw them just walking?
Oh, yeah. They were set like Urban Outfitters
for no reason.
Mm.
It was cool.
No reason.
They go out as a band too?
Yeah, I guess they always have to be together. It's part of their.
That's cute.
Oh my god!
See, they always have to.
This
no.
is how we learn.
I wanted to do that.
I always do. We need to represent the DDP, but by doing so, I don't actually want to be with any of these people.
No.
Yeah. Nope.
No.
We don't hang out
who
at all.
Who have we been compared to other than that?
My dad was a huge Cranberries fan, you know, and he's like, you guys kind of sound like the New Age Cranberries. It's like.
So we started doing a cover
from
them.
Okay, now, you know what?
That was cool.
Can I say F your dad? Yeah, because New Age Cranberries. Cranberries is something that I grew up with, and when I hear New Age, that just put me in an age category.
Right.
Old age.
Hey, it's because you're old.
Hashtag,
dun, dun,
that's
dun.
Why. Hashtag F your dad.
I'm blocking out that window when I do my shifts.
What about if the Cranberries were around now?
That still puts a timestamp on it.
Yeah, there's still a time. Mm-hmm. The new Cranberries.
Led by Sinead O'Connor.
Yes.
Okay.
Don't fight it. Pass
there
it to
we
us,
go.
Guys.
My favorite thing to get compared to is Paramore, because Paramore is my favorite band ever.
That's your baby.
And so anytime someone's like, you guys sound like Paramore, I'm like, bless you. I didn't even have to pay you to say that.
But I will still.
But here.
Well, okay. If we're going to talk about paying to say things, what do you want to pay us to say? And by the way, how much?
I'll give you a high five.
A high five?
Yeah.
Well, that's more I've made in 7 years. That's a good point.
Can I ask her a girly question?
Yeah.
Oh, God.
Okay. Yes, so, like, queen. How deep into Paramore are you? Are you, like, so aware of the whole, like, she's still Sherry Dupree's husband? Like,
no,
are
you
that deep into the Paramore?
Sounds fairly girly.
You know how deep I'm the deepest.
Someone's
like,
getting stabbed.
Deep, yeah. Deep stuff.
Because, like, I feel like they're like, because I liked Paramore, and then the Isley stuff happened, and I was like, I felt like I had to take a side for, like, a year, at least until she
That's
remarried
reasonable.
With Max Bemis. Because, like, I was like, after their first kid, I was like, okay, I forgive you, Haley. Like, shit's meant to
yeah,
be.
Yeah, and I mean, like, Paramore played the wow. Save Mart Center, and Truth I think I saw Isley at Neighborhood
thrift,
right?
So yeah, I think Haley's doing okay.
Yeah, they're doing fine. They're doing
you know
fine.
Because success means it's totally fine to steal somebody's husband. That
I
makes sense.
So.
Yeah.
If
yeah.
someone more successful would like to steal me. No, that's
oh,
not how this works.
Well, like
I got
the
you,
lead
baby girl.
Singer, she used to
girl,
be married to Adam Lazar,
right?
Right? Like,
yeah,
I'm gonna tweet that.
I think that's a like metric, but a lot more personal. I've heard them like on like
yeah.
actual like their disc,
metric then, opened for them at the same
yeah,
dinner.
I saw that.
Sucked.
Yeah.
They sucked.
By the way, on mic right now, it's Nay Nay.
I disagree.
It's
I love Metric.
Hold on, hold on.
Girl power.
I want to recognize. I want to recognize Superfan. That I almost like quasi fear that he's going to ask me to sign his dick at some point tonight. but Nay Nay's in here. He's been hanging out. But you know, we love so. Having fans. So. And I'll give you $20 later.
are you going to sign his dick at Famous Dave's?
As long as he gets close enough.
Just walk up to you want me to sign your dick?
And I have a nice I have a short signature, so I'm good. I'm covered there.
Boom.
Your time playing here in the Valley, anywhere else, whatever, there is a topic that I love getting into with bands. And it's a big thing I know with, especially here in the Valley, bands versus promoters versus venues.
Okay.
What is?
I don't want to be in this conversation.
Dibs.
Bad.
smart man.
I'm not looking for name dropping or anything. I'm looking for how do we make hashtag make Fresno better.
It's already there.
Hashtag for the
yeah. Hashtag. That's the closest to millennial I get.
I wrote it down when we were talking about my serial killing. Go ahead.
What doesn't work? What does work? What would you like to see happen for everyone?
Go pre-sales. CJ, go.
Oh, man.
Fight, CJ, fight.
This
go,
is
CJ.
That question I never thought I would actually finally get asked. I think the most important thing for a venue is I think a lot of venues locally have room to improve, and there's a lot that are doing it well. And just quality sound and someone who knows what they're doing behind the board. I think a good show, even a bad band, can be made to sound good sometimes if you got the right people in there, the right equipment, the right person who knows what they're doing. Some rooms are so cool here locally, and like the audience is fun and it's so fun to play, but we just don't get good sound, and so that can affect us as performers, and that can affect the audience participation. It can affect so much things. So I think good sound is huge. One thing that we haven't had it happen in a while, but know who you're booking and book them with people that it makes sense with.
Mm-hmm.
When we first started playing, we did a gig at the Roxy down in Hollywood. And we got booked with a bunch of like singer-songwriters because we were a band with a girl in it.
And then that one crazy band from Vegas.
Yeah, and then some other weird stuff.
Oh, that was another LA show. LA's fun.
LA is.
Well, you're from a shithole, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Do you get pegged as that when you go outside of the Valley? You're
not
from
really.
Fresno, so.
Oh, that's where I get my meth.
Yeah.
And my car stolen.
Do you have any with you?
Are you driving
something
a Honda
that was
Civic?
Really frustrating, though, was at a lot of those shows, because I am a, because of my plumbing, they're like, cool. Another female fronted anything. Like, oh, they decide that female is a genre.
Wait, which door?
Kind of thing.
Which door do you push
right?
open?
Right? It's like that with comedy, too. It sucks.
The brave, courageous one.
Yeah, which yeah. door? Just to make sure the crowd knows.
The winner of people's hearts.
Yes, not the winner of gold.
Okay, so when you push in the Wheaties door, and then they know where to plug you in. That was also phrasing.
phrasing.
Hashtag phrasing.
No,
I don't know. That was just something. I actually, at that same LA show at the Roxy, they tried to kick me out because they were like, sorry, no girlfriends. Wow. Girlfriends have to stand outside. I was like, I'm the lead singer and I write everything.
Rules are rules, lady.
Doesn't that suck? I was at the San Jose Improv and they made my boyfriend sit in separate seating and they looked at me like, are you sure you're the comedian and not him? Yeah. And I'm like, yes, yes, it's me.
Oh,
I call that microaggression.
Don't you hate that? Like, like as just a woman, like we have not come so far that, like,
oh my God, I'm hearing
sad.
Monday.
Oh,
calm down,
shit.
Everyone.
Yeah, go. But did they make you sell pre-sales to your own show out of town?
Dude, oh yeah, pre-sales.
Sometimes pay to play.
I have an entire separate rant about pre-sales.
Do your job.
Actually,
as a promoter.
You know what? Yeah. I want to hear this.
I want to hear.
I do not. I think it's an outdated thing. I think it's geared towards.
Three promoters right now just said, "Fuck you guys! You're never playing a show."
Thanks.
It's okay. We weren't going to play them anyways. They're pre-sales.
Suck it.
Pre-sales does not have the artist's best intention in mind.
No, it does not.
There it is.
Yeah. It can work sometimes, but very seldomly has it ever been worth our while to do. I think there are better ways to get people at shows. I think there are better ways to promote those shows. We're big on helping promoting the shows, too. It's not like I'm just expect to be paid and show up. Like, we're going to push it online. We plan all of this stuff out.
We don't need to go knocking doors and begging
people to pay for tickets. And people in Fresno especially, we don't plan that fucking far ahead. Like, you're not going to buy a show or tickets to a show that's in 2 months because...
It's a walk-up town.
It is. Mm-hmm. That needs to be the hottest thing that night. I even with promoting four shows that we do, I'll kind of like do like a base invite a month ahead of time. And then 2 weeks closer, then I bring a few more people in. Mm-hmm. And then week of, that's when you do all the heavy promotion. There's just better ways to do it to where everyone can still win. You don't need a 30-band bill, everyone selling 90 pre-sales to play at $20 each so that we can make $40 and maybe play in the middle. It's just... I'm not 15 anymore. I'm not buying into that.
Yeah.
Pay me to come there. We will work our asses off and get people there. But there's just better ways to do it.
To our non-musician listeners, pay to play. To explain it, it's usually like you get handed a stack of tickets that usually you pay in advance for, or you get them on honor, but you have to either show up with tickets or money. Mm-hmm. And balance it all out, you know, the ledger and all that.
Yeah. And then after all that legwork, you don't see that money.
Mm-hmm. I have a question, and it's something I've been talking with bands coming through, and now we are working on something in December, and
I love them.
I've done this. They're an awesome band.
I preferred their last album.
Yeah. Last December? Yeah. Mm.
No, the 2012 one was really good.
Yep. Dang.
At the end of times, arguably.
An idea was coming up. Now, I've been in bands. I was so good that I played in front of no one. And I
you
never
couldn't handle you.
I never got to do the pay to play. Like, we just avoided that. We were also really
so lucky. Dude.
Well, we were too cool.
You stopped playing in bands after 2007.
Oh, you remember the conversation?
I
played
like
at Big
rampant.
Game for like three yeah. days a week. No one paid right? for pre-sales when they went to Big Game. People just
right?
showed up.
Mm-hmm. Big Game was the
And then after
shit.
Like 2007, 2008 hit, and it's like every promoter was like, oh yeah, pre-sales is a thing. And I'm like, no, it's not.
Well, see, one of the things I work on here is a community effort. And we go out once a year to do an actual event. Mm-hmm. But to try to work with everyone, anybody that's a part, like we're all kind of a united team. But I don't want to fuck over any band. I want to make sure they get their moment, get their money, get something out of it.
Yeah.
And I will never say, you know, you'll get great exposure, because we still have never gotten exposure on the show.
There it is. Playing for exposure for years, and
it's okay. Al Pacino's sitting on the toilet.
Well, it
right
depends
now.
On the exposure.
What if for
that's all the exposure we need?
If you're looking for exposure, I think you can go to Famous Dave's.
Damn it, I'm out. That's it. My headphones are coming off.
What if promoters start hitting you up and said, we'll give you tickets, a stack of 20 for whatever the door costs. We'll just say $10 at the door. Mm-hmm. You get 20 tickets, and you get 100% of it. And you can choose to sell them or hand them out to your friends. Is that something that's a starting point to work between bands and promoters? Because I know that's like one of the big keys.
We don't really mess with that still.
Mm-mm. Okay. That's low incentive and low reward, though. Like, yeah, I could just give them away. The getting to keep it for you selling it, that's already
just like
better.
A glorified guest list at that point.
Yeah.
Because okay. You could sell them for, like, half price or nothing.
You just fucked my entire world.
Yeah, you could.
Yep. Yeah.
But if... You have 30 bands, though, that you're trying to put in this building, and we're all doing that. I don't know. It gets messy.
What's a good way to go about it for the band? To make the band happy, but band also needing to recognize that there's unfortunately, middleman and a venue, and everybody's got to make everybody happy.
The band needs at least drink tickets. Oh my God, that's my job. Don't worry. Could literally not pay a band, but tell them you have drink tickets, and they'll be like,
okay,
all right,
this is worth it.
And then you send the bass player to go talk to the promoter and be like, hey, do we get drink tickets? Oh, that's my job. That's my job.
Drinking, okay, for
ticket sales and how to do all of that. I think online sales are totally underutilized, at least locally. I think if you can have bands have their own link for tickets, and that's how you track who's buying from who, I think that's already more reasonable than giving me a stack of tickets. We're all adults. We all work 40 hours a week. I don't have time to then, on top of that, go out and push tickets, you know?
Careful, you just made yourself old.
I know.
Yeah.
Me and my damn benefits.
Right? Ain't nobody got time for that.
This,
okay, and my 401k.
I mean, but with online sales, too, you got to think of those service fees. I know a lot of people who have wanted to buy tickets to our shows online. They're like, oh, well, there's a service fee, which kind of counteracts it being a pre-sale. So I'm just going to buy at the door.
$5.36 convenience fee per ticket. Yeah. Like, what? Who's convenience? My wallet?
What's convenience about that?
My Robertitos, bitches.
Yeah. That's burrito.
Oh, damn. That sounds nice.
That's my sport burrito.
I think at some point we need to do like a full week long, just bring in bands, promoters, whatever. Because, you know, Kevin, you're looking at me like with that face. Yeah. I have ideas. But we need to get something even more serious, more heavy.
Mm-hmm.
It starts with this.
Big time.
It's time for Molestar Kevin's questions.
It is?
Yeah.
Yeah, I like that too. My ego's all swole. Here we go.
First question,
dickhole.
CJ. Yes. Which one of you in the band is most likely to OD on heroin?
Oh man.
Jesus.
Or which one of you is the songwriter?
Oh, okay.
Probably a better way to put that.
Our ex-keyboard player would be the most likely.
Ex because he's already done?
But also Christine writes the songs. This was ultimately her project. And then when we were dating when she started it. And she was playing live just like her and her keyboard. And I was like, this is really cool, babe. You're really talented. We're going to be a band now because it's going to be way more fun to watch. And she was like, no. And I was like, yes. And then we got a drummer, and I started playing live with her.
Cool story, man.
But she wouldn't let me play guitar because she was like, you always fucking try to take everything over. And I was like, no, I don't. Also, I got us a bass player.
Okay, to be fair, they're easy to get.
Yeah,
they may not be good.
Time a dozen.
Is that John?
Guitar players or bass players?
Bass.
What?
We got three right
now. No, I'm a bit like, raise your hand.
This is where you all were then, because I could never find
you know it's funny?
We got the bass.
Bass players are just guitarists that can't count to six.
I'd like to see you slap a guitar.
No, oh, no. You, nobody wants to hear that.
I don't have the length.
I used to play upright. I know all about slap life.
If you play the bass like the drums, it actually sounds pretty cool.
See, I sync with
I just pictured you alone in a room with a drumstick and a bass, and you're just abusing the shit out of it.
It's like Jimi Hendrix, but retarded at the same time.
Second question.
Speaking of keyboardists and bassists, which one of you hates the ex-keyboardist or haces bassist by default? Hacists. Bunch of hasists.
What was the question?
Oh, this is a focus point. Okay.
Which one of you hates the keyboardist or the bassist by default?
Oh, we're not going to do
one
that.
One of you does. You're a band. This is band law.
Mm-hmm.
Wait, who hates someone by default?
Yeah.
I hate everyone by default.
Yeah,
does that count?
She still does not like that we're up there with her.
But typically, the keyboardist and or the bassist, if there's not a keyboardist, is usually the most hated person in the band.
Okay.
Really?
I would say our drummer is the most hated person in the band.
Josh is the worst.
Josh is the worst.
He's the absolute worst.
Josh. We literally have a thing like, okay, you're the worst for the
here
week.
At Amoret, we're
he
all about
thought,
breaking
he's
stereotypes.
He's had that badge for quite some time.
Like he wanted
thought
to come
that
and you
this
like,
was
no.
Thursday. I said Wednesday three times.
I like that they're targeting the guy.
Is
that
he the one that's supposed to bring those
bullshit? It just works out that way. Sometimes I'm the worst, you know.
Your drummer's my girlfriend? Because she's typically 24 hours late.
She might be listening.
She can hear us, Chris.
Josh is special. It's also, you know, it's CJ's little brother. So, and now my little brother, kind of. So,
Yeah, right.
So it's easy just to like shit on him.
Of course.
You know?
That's why you got married.
Easy.
So you could do that and not get in trouble.
So I can shit on his little brother and slap pop him.
Shit's like shit out two that girls, shit. One cup. Yeah.
Again, hashtag for
everything
the other
about that entire video.
Yeah, I'd watch it. except it's not on video, so I can't.
It wouldn't. Oh my God.
So we
not,
call a callback.
No.
Dear God.
Question the third.
Let's do this. Let's do JJ.
JJ? You mean CJ?
No, JJ.
There's JJ and CJ. I know.
Jesus Christ.
Catch up.
See, I wrote this shit down.
Catch the fuck up, Dowdy.
God damn it, sound guy.
Who would win in a fight? A, Sam Elliott's hair, circa Roadhouse, 1989. Let's get a visual.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I have that video.
That visual's fresh.
No, hold on. Sound guy totally fucked up on this.
Yes, he did.
Let's switch this up then. Let's take this to Christine. I'm going to give you the next question why Dowdy preps everything he's already prepped for and for some reason can't fight it.
Not me. Intern Pete.
Since you're now married, there's
you. Shut up!
Excuse me.
Intern Pete. That's not cool.
In the form of a song, explain to anybody out there who doesn't know, the best to your ability, how to change a baby's diaper. Like Les Miserables style.
You want me to like
singing?
Sing?
Yeah. Well, like, yeah, like talk sing. Like Russell Crowe did at everyone in that movie.
At everyone.
I still don't see why he was singing in The Commander, so that was really weird.
So I can just like do whatever.
Daddy, can we get like, oh, do the kick intro? That's got a little.
Oh my God, you are asking way too much of sound guy.
I know,
he can't pull
things,
that off.
This is tough.
I'm still trying to convince him to type Sam Elliott.
If he can count to one more, he could be a bassist.
Oh my God, you're a dickhole.
Hashtag
right.
Fucking Pete.
Focus on one thing at a time.
How to change a diaper, Les Miserables sing speaking style, as soon as Dowdy can load up some music.
Nope.
This is how it's not happening.
I guess you're gonna have to do it acapella.
Acapella.
No. What am I doing?
You don't know acapella.
You're looking for two photos.
You are a bassist.
I take offense to that.
I'm sorry.
You're not Kenneth, so that's still better than being.
So there's this baby and there's poop in his diaper.
Being Kenneth.
What diaper's got to get changed. How do I do it?
Send you guys to hell.
As LL Cool J once famously said,
mm-hmm, definitely
meet your mama.
I'm gonna knock you out. Mama said knock you out. I'm gonna knock you out. Mama said. Knock you out.
So step one, knock
your kid out.
Step one, knock out baby.
You know, there's no fight
step
back.
Two,
there's no pee.
Change diaper.
That's correct.
Ding.
Ding.
Step three, question mark. Step four,
this is
profit.
Why I take birth control pills.
Excellent.
Wait, tell us
also
more.
The right answer.
Nope. Plan C.
All right.
That's the one with the coat hanger, right?
C for
no. That's not cool.
Plan copper.
All right.
Here we go.
Pregunta cuatro.
Are we still skipping question two?
I don't know.
Have you not gotten your shit together yet?
Did we find Roadhouse hair or no?
All right, you know, just because you sit in the booth outside of my flailing arms doesn't mean you can just judge me in my
studio.
I'm Chris Dowdy.
Look at me. I'm on radio. I do radio stuff.
I don't mean to brag, but I am the voice of Gold Diggers. So,
wow.
I would like to think I'm very talented.
Huh.
It makes you a slut.
Sound boy!
Damn.
Fucking Pete.
Daddy did something right.
Recognize your voice from Gold. Whoa.
I just found...
fucking Pete. All right, we're good.
We just found Sam Elliott's hair.
Here we go.
Okay, we found Sam Elliott's hair.
Who would win in a fight? Sam Elliott's
hair. Pregunta cuatro.
We know.
Jesus, sound boy. Boy.
Sam Elliott's hair, circa 1989.
I love
movie
this movie,
Roadhouse,
by the way.
Or
Roadhouse.
Patrick Swayze's bulge, circa 1989, in the movie Roadhouse.
You didn't tell me to look up his dick.
Everyone knows what his bulge looks like.
It's like that.
Looks like that, but lower.
Wait, that's not his arm?
Oh.
Is that a cup? Or... Oh, I'm looking at the wrong guy.
One of these hair slash bulges.
Does that look like the one you saw at Famous Dave?
Put baby on my bulge.
You know, I actually didn't look at the other dude's dick, so I don't know. I'm going to go with Sam Elliott's hair.
That's correct. It is. Go back to that photo.
That's amazing hair, by the way.
Go back to this
Wish
way.
Had
the,
hair.
To the hair.
It's like uppercut Sam status.
Photo.
Sam Elliott?
Yeah.
Okay.
TKO.
Tell me that is nothing less than Dude. The most alpha male lion mane.
Wow. I strive for that every day. And then
I don't know. CJ, do you want to unleash?
I'm not ready to let this down.
Okay.
Careful, ladies. If you stare too long, you will be pregnant.
Oh, shit.
Listen. I already am.
Yeah, I'm there.
Now you're going to have to knock out our baby.
And then finally...
I'm not ready to knock out no babies.
There's a stairwell nearby.
I forgot what question number we were on.
Quadro. Here we go.
Question 9.
That was the fifth one.
You got a button. Where the hell are we?
What?
Shut the fuck up, Kenneth.
This one is a little social experiment. This is actually kind of there's multiple questions on this fifth one.
Kill all gingers.
That's the answer to the first question.
They have no souls.
So we'll just start with Christine. Christine, little social experiment.
Okay.
Uh-oh.
What are the first 7 odd numbers? Go. You can even say it out loud.
1, 3, 5, 7, 11.
I forgot 9.
9 isn't a prime number, asshole.
No.
I said odd.
Odd? Yeah. I thought it was prime. Odd. I was going prime numbers.
You're doing way too much.
Yeah.
I was like, 9 is divisible by 3. Okay. Well,
I'm a math robot.
Nerd.
Okay. Well, you're not an asshole. I take it back.
7 was 4.
Hashtags.
Keep going.
7.
What?
9, 11, 13, 15.
JJ.
17.
Mm-hmm.
Say this word backwards. There's 3 of them. Cat.
Tack.
Saw.
Was. Was.
Was.
Right.
That was beautiful.
Was. Step.
Mother.
Tesp. Teps.
Step would be pets.
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 Jesus.
Thank you, Riley's, for this amazing beer that you have given me today.
I'm gonna reveal the answer to this experiment when we're done here. CJ.
Yes.
What do you call your uncle's wife?
A whore. I'm kidding. I don't have an uncle.
The answer is correct. What would you call your uncle's wife?
Aunt.
Mm-hmm. Back to Christine. What is the opposite of up?
Down.
Outside.
Inside.
Asleep.
Awake.
And finally, JJ, when you're unemployed, it's because you don't have a...
job.
Thank you.
Work ethic.
Now, after we break this down after the break, Dowdy's going to go through and get all 3 of you to admit that 9/11 was an inside job.
That's not going to fucking happen.
Christine, do you remember being on Great Day?
We were on Great Day on 9/11.
Damn.
Like, last year. And time Kobe came up to us, I just wanted to be like, Jet Fuel doesn't melt steel beams! Like, so how long have you been a band?
Best quote.
So coming up after the break, we're going to be playing Jihad or Bust again.
Yay! Oh my God, please no.
Is Trump going to guest star on that?
Oh,
he's not here today.
If you look in the corner of the studio, you might see a tower.
Oh, right there. That's right next to the 30,000 emails that Hillary deleted.
That's why it was destroyed.
That was the confetti at the DNC.
Dude, no, that's the Russians.
Some say it was the NSA.
Oh, God.
Some love to the band here.
Way too woke.
Oh, some love to the band here. You guys got a show coming up on August 11th.
Oh, shit. Really?
We do?
Yeah. I'm letting you know. I
didn't we got to practice, text. Guys.
Now, you guys have to sell 30 tickets. And you get 30 cents each.
So it's going to be a cappella.
And no beer.
And no drink.
We'll send
tickets.
Somebody with a boombox in our EP. And we're just
so we're sending Kenneth. Yeah.
The show is outside the DMV.
You'd be surprised. I'll probably actually sell a lot.
But the good thing is they're...
which DMV?
No. I'm sorry. If you're at the DMV, you want to be the first band.
Yeah.
Because that's a captive audience right there.
Yeah,
you've got 90-year-old grandmas and the dude with the dog in the cart.
Yeah. Yeah. Cart dog guy.
Have you ever been to the DMV on Olive? It's the prettiest DMV.
You wouldn't think that.
It almost looks like the airport. I almost thought I was about to hop on a plane to Nashville.
I took pictures of the DMV and sent them to CJ. I was like, this is the prettiest DMV ever.
Surrounded by a prison fence.
I totally took pictures also.
It's so nice.
When you give a meth head a makeover.
That is quality.
It shouldn't always look like that.
By the way, next week on AMC, meth head makeovers.
Oh, my God.
The we give him teeth and hope.
It almost looks like
only a couple of teeth.
We do have a show on the 11th. Yes. I just confirmed.
That is at Frank's Place.
Shit will be lit.
Shit will be lit. We're playing with a band from LA. I think they're called Sounds Like Disco.
And they do not sound like disco. We looked them up, and we're like, you should have been called Sounds Like Anything Besides Disco.
They sound like Mercury Bullet from what I've heard.
Mercury Bullet coming up next here on Longbox.
I actually like Mercury Bullet.
That's an old school reference. That's cool.
So far, we've talked about Flight 409 and Mercury Bullet tonight. Yeah. Hello, operator.
I like the.
Can I talk to God?
Is there an astronaut that I can say hello
about,
to? Or
how about some love? Like, where can we find you guys at?
Right now, we are.
Oh, don't be that guy.
Okay,
you're gonna be that guy. I know it.
You can find us literally anywhere on the internet.
Everything is Facebook/Amoret Music, Twitter Amoret Music, Amoret.band is our website. Anywhere that social media exists
is AmoretUp.com. Things like that.
All right, awesome.
What the hell?
we're gonna get a little bit more on the plug at the end. We
is
do
Joe
have
Piper on there still.
We
no?
do have. We have tickets that we are giving away tonight, not to see Amoret. But if you call in, we'll tell
it's
you
fine.
It's Amoret, but you'll see this other band. The Entourage is presenting Westfield Massacre at Fulton 55. Tell you what, we'll take the first caller after I get done talking at 492-0450, and you can go and see
Hello,
butcher.
Did I win?
You work at a station. You know what bullshit I'm about to pull.
I'm still on hold.
And when we're going to take a break.
Oh my God, the 10th caller, more like the first thing Hammer sees.
Don't pull
lazy.
The curtain.
Yeah, don't show me how the burger's
made. We're gonna take a quick break. We're going to take a break. And when we come back, we got DJ Voice Off. But I do want to leave you with this right now. Amazing band. It's called Mercury Bullet Danger Zone here on Longbox.fm. We'll be right back.
So I love sitting in there, and Hammer like goes, okay, let's do this, and he's sitting there, and then the first thing comes, he's like, what's up, you're the 10th caller! Like, you're such a dick!
Old radio days were like 100th caller. Ah!
Fuck!
No, it's up there.
You're calling my face!
Caller number three, we'll get
the fuck is wrong with
you? Caller number 3 on 93.4.
Anywhere in the vicinity of your long-ass alarm?
This is my song, buddy.
Couldn't have to warn you.
Gross. Santa's little helper.
Right?
I'm totally getting French toast after this.
French toast?
French toast.
Bruh.
I hop Kong.
I'm fucking deli.
Coming at my boy all wrong.
I wish I could afford French toast. I need to use you for voices for commercials, sir.
All right, Dirt Daddy Podcast is back.
DJ Khaled.
Nope, not that one yet.
Sorry.
We've had some rotations. We're doing the musical chairs. Oh, you're going to do that to me? I would never recommend doing that to me.
Do you not have the reggae horn? Yes!
Hell yes.
I need you to keep that very close.
All right.
I'm crying.
Well, all right, Christine, you're challenging. This is the DJ Voice Off. And Christine, I'll let you describe it.
It's a challenge with voices about DJs. Let you down. Search You don't even have the version from the RNC.
Okay, you and I, we're gonna have some issues. We're gonna throw down.
She'll never give you up.
See, okay, I was worried.
Wait, did you just try and call
Donald
Synchrony?
Trump will never let you down.
Christine, I was worried about you being on this show.
We're the best coworkers
being
ever.
That you work with me, and how, you know, I've done this in the past where things kind of come back, and
you know, I was really concerned about you when I saw the amount of energy drinks in the back of your truck.
She texts me. She's like, what is it, like 20? I'm concerned for my coworkers' like well-being,
like his pee, kind of,
like, or his heart might
healthy.
Explode, and I
his
have to watch
melts
it.
Through steel beams.
Your boss, my boss. John Austin has been on the show.
Handsome motherfucker.
Oh no.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah. No, it was a great time.
He was allowed with this, like, the dirtiness of it.
He liked
claim?
This. Well, good. We were a little bit
he
nicer.
Banned Beer Friday, kinda.
Well,
it has to be in the lobby now under like a sink.
I got the speech about bringing in food to the studio because
well,
I had my energy
ants.
Drink in there. So I got the fear of John, and he is a scary man. Like,
you know,
don't
he hasn't
piss him
said
off.
Anything to me. He's a fantastic man.
Oh my god!
All right, so
look at me,
on to the game.
I know everything.
On to the game. So yeah, the DJ
it's,
voice
it's
off.
On.
I'm. Oh wait, we
I'm
were
just
still doing
way
that.
Better at
oh yeah, we're still doing
you,
that. I'm going to give you a piece of paper here, and you're going to read one of the.
Wait,
items
we have to talk about the teams.
There's teams.
Oh yeah, get the teams.
Yeah, we're going.
Let me guess.
We're going to go.
It's Amoret.
Nope.
Damn it.
The internet voted on this.
Bullshit.
The internet
you're
voted
on
this.
Who's
on
the internet?
Right
everybody.
We have...
Let the internet decide.
We have two teams going on tonight.
So we got Team Hitler and Team
nope.
Gamergate? Or
nope.
What? I mean, that's what the internet usually picks.
I'm
Hitler.
On
team Steel Beam versus Team Jet Fuel.
It's
because...
it's funny because one cannot defeat the other.
Team Almoretto Slim over here. You guys got named Team Fam Bam. Fam
Ooh.
Band.
Fam Band?
Yeah, and then that's Team real. DDP is Team Sadness.
Oh.
Hashtag Team Sadness.
Okay. Hashtag
I could
Team
see
Kenneth.
That.
But yeah, exactly. But we changed it for him. Don't worry. The sadness is coming up in the next segment. So it's simple and easy. It's going to go between one team, and then the next one has to perform. You have to read what's given to you. Alex is going to be running this.
Mm-hmm.
And Cotty. Hi, Cotty. How you doing?
Hi.
I do this
okay.
The job.
Hi.
That's we got.
A
tiny we
oh, no.
got
it's
different.
A tiny hat, right? I was like,
"Whose hat does
yeah. what child left this at a Garth Brooks show?" Like,
we have.
Did you
Mexico,
get that at the
Ramate
okay?
off a 5-year-old?
Not
come
country.
On.
We got different characters in this hat, and
is
you're going to have to read.
Is this hat a little bit country, or is it a little bit rock and roll? To the polls we go.
It's
call
a little Aerosmith.
492-0450-559.
I'm going to do it to you.
Hashtag all right. Country.
So I'm going to let Cotty, because she only reads things in a British accent, I'm going to let her poll.
Cotty.
It happens.
All right. Let's go. Do we go age versus beauty as far as DDP? Do we or Team Sadness?
CJ
do we go
Vanna,
first?
I went on both of those.
I need you guys to do Rochambeau right now.
Okay.
CJ Vanna right
let's
now.
Let's do it. Let's do it.
1, 2, 3, punch each other to nuts.
Wait, you're 1, 2, 3, go, right? You're not like a go on three
yeah, yeah.
wrong person?
Even this
one,
is a thing?
1, 2, 3, go. All right.
That's my baby.
Amoret, do you want to go
okay.
first or second?
Yes, I want to go second.
Okay.
So that I can know what I have to beat.
Okay, Team Sadness is going to be Vanna, clearly Kenneth, and
Renee.
Hey, Nay. You want to be on a mic.
Hey, Nay.
Congratulations.
Hello.
You now are part
whip.
Of this.
Watch
so,
him, Renee.
From a veteran, let's go. Kenneth has to read first. Cotty, can you pull a name?
Well, I'm fucked.
What's our team name again?
What's our team name?
Team Sadness.
You're Team Sadness.
I'll
like
pull
my
the
mood
name.
Right now.
Sadness. All right. Kenneth, this works for you in no way. You have to read the first part as hipster. She's already making fun of you.
All right, so Kenneth.
I'm so ready.
So this is these are the how to be gay in 10 easy steps.
You sound like you're talking for KFRR. No.
I want
what?
Kenneth, you're going to read number 1, please.
As a hipster. Tuck your nuts up a little bit.
I don't know how to do this. how do you
like a lot.
Well, your shirt's like tight enough. You should do it.
And totes.
Baby gap.
Fuck. He already goes there.
Her shirt, his shirt, sponsored by.
Going
it
green.
Hurts.
It hurts.
My armpits have no blood flow.
Bleeding nipples.
Why is baby?
Come on, man!
What the hell's with your bleeding nipples?
I'm here for the beer. Shirt's a little too tight. All right.
Step one.
#charity.
Have a diva. Having a strong female icon is somehow integral or whatever
integral.
To the gay identity. The diva of choice doesn't need to be one of the familiar, like, one-named ladies of whatever. Madonna, you know, Cher, Judy, Liza, Barbara, Mariah Gaga, or both Bettys. Just pick one and never, ever, 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 ever leave her. Ever. Ever.
That sounded really gay.
Oh, ever. My.
I don't think that was hipster. I think that was gay.
Maybe that's where he was
going. I don't see the difference.
That's so not easy.
So he's saying that he liked dick so before it was cool.
All right, all right.
I'm sorry. Stop. I'm really sorry.
Who's stepping up for Team Fan Band?
I can. Step
we're gonna
up.
Go. With, we're gonna start
okay.
off. Christine,
you feeling
right
brave?
Now, Christine, this is in your wheelhouse.
You're number
you do
two.
This all day long, right?
I need you.
Allegedly,
to number.
I don't do a lot of character stuff. I'm like, hey, come to this place. They have the freshest ingredients, and they're conveniently located at this street and this fucking street.
So would you call, would you call yourself a, I don't know,
some
a radio prostitute?
No airbags.
A radio prostitute?
Yeah.
Maybe.
Okay, good, because
oh,
it's actually
great.
Prostitute. Go ahead, go.
For the second one?
Yeah,
number two.
So the second step is dress in drag.
I have to go now.
You just.
It will unleash a personality you didn't even know you had in you. And it will make you okay with your femininity. One thing, when the femme is totally in control, it will never make you fear it again.
Good job, CJ.
That was cheers. The first time I've heard that.
Cheers.
is it unanimous?
Swing.
Is it unanimous?
Yeah. Even I'm saying that.
Okay.
Yeah,
team fan band.
Welcome. Yeah, fan band.
Gets it. Yes. Gets it. Gets
bravo,
it. Good job.
Bravo.
Go to Gold Diggers.
All right.
Oh, hey, guys.
I will.
Round.
Round two.
Round
I have
two.
My ones ready.
We're gonna go. Nene versus JJ.
Nene JJ.
Nene.
We get Nene JJ.
JJ.
All right.
Yeah,
Howdy,
let's
just pull
let
the fucking
winner
name.
Pick. Let the winner Ramos. Pick. Christine, pull a name.
Still, it's a prostitute, or?
Well, we all are right now.
A WWE wrestler. Which 1041 is giving out tickets for right now.
August 8th, you can go see.
So you're going to do number three, Nene, and you got to read it as a WWE wrestler.
Damn it, I wanted that one.
Shit, I could have done that.
Oh, yeah! There is a complex network of looks and signals to men use to attract each other. Yeah! Something that makes gay men much more attuned to the body language and perception than our straight counterparts. Oh, yeah!
Sounds well.
Snap into a Slim Jim! Learn how to do that. Not only will it improve your gay experience, but the way you interact with everyone. Oh, yeah!
Hashtag,
street cruising
oh, yeah.
is mostly dead. No, it can't be done in the grinder, but a trip to a bathhouse would teach you all you ever need to know. Oh, yes! Number two is Slim Jim!
All right.
Yep. Eat me.
All right, who's up for Team Fan Band?
JJ is.
JJ.
All
right. Do you want me to
pull the
pick
name.
It again?
Yeah, winner picks.
Okay.
To keep it fair, you know, this is a real election and stuff.
First one
dude, I'm not looking in the hat.
I am so sorry. Chola.
You're going to read number four there. Just make sure you read the title as well.
Know your papers.
You gotta know your papers.
Hey, vato.
Hey, vato. Oh if only God. People knew. I'm just kidding. I messed it up already.
Sound like Dowdy Girl.
If only so people will... What?
Yeah, it's written horribly.
Who wrote this shit?
It's written Chola.
Dowdy.
Gary Chola.
It's written in Chola, who didn't graduate high school.
Like right now, right now, or like later.
Better than that, growing up in the hood of Colonia.
Hashtag Thug Life Jared.
Anyway, this
that's just what
so
I say.
Jared, this is a competition. Read the piece.
You're losing points.
Just one.
Know point. About poppers.
I know, right?
I sound like a gay person.
Yeah, yeah.
It sounds like a gay chola.
So yeah, chola.
So
yeah.
All cholas are gay to you.
Dude, it's like
it's a loaded statement. Don't answer. Keep
Yo
going.
Yo soy gay chola.
Yo soy gay
chola. Chola is a sisterhood.
I feel like Christine could have won this without us.
Will you get your jokes about Rush and Jungle Juice? I sound like fucking...
You sounded great when you started.
Keep going.
And then
keep going.
You started listening to yourself.
I sound like Pauly Shore right now.
Give yourself a good eye.
I want to like...
Really?
I want to cruise the mountain right now. That's...
Think of your inspiration.
I'm sorry. I'm going to call this.
Yeah.
I want to give it to you, but... Team
Nene.
Sadness.
Team Sadness. Nene gets a point.
Good job, Woo! Nene.
Gracias.
Recipe.
Gracias, eh?
All right.
She can roll her R's.
Christine was the mascot for Sanger High School.
I was very sad when I found out that I wasn't half Mexican, so I tried to. She's white. Why can't you Mexican. Roll your R's?
He's like, rah.
That only happens when you're doing.
Oral sex?
Kardashian.
Oh, I'm sorry.
What? Go. So nope. I grew up in Easton, and all my I was the only white person I knew. So I really wanted. I was like, I have to be this. I have to be this race. And I thought my dad was half Mexican, and then he told me he was white, and I cried. Like I was 8 years old, and I cried. I was like, I'm not Mexican. I'm just white.
That was an existential crisis.
I like
Taco Bell.
That's not Mexican. You fucking eat. Not even.
That's
close.
Mexican. Right.
You don't eat taco. Cállate su boca.
All right, Vanna, you're up.
Speaks better Spanish than half the room.
And Nene gets...
Shayate?
El sombrero.
Cállate, boca.
That's what I heard just... Hashtag Shayate.
Okay. Nene, what you got? How's she reading this?
Soccer announcement.
Soccer announcer.
Goal!
No! Don't do that on my mic. I hate you.
What stuff are we on?
You're number 5.
Oh, this should be easy.
Protest! Get out there with a picket sign and some anger and fight for your rights! You can collect signatures for marriage equality or you can join the Occupy Protest! Yeah. And I'm giving equality, but never stop fighting. Pinkie Pie by your side. There are plenty of causes that need fundraising.
Wiggle!
Which can easily be done over brunch, a.k.a. art that somehow is not on this list.
Even your dog's getting scared.
Okay, so shit.
That's like the quarter Mexican coming out of nowhere.
She's like, that's too Wiggle. Much Mexican.
Pinky's over here. All right, if you could hand that paper.
I'm at my 25%
CJ. Hand that paper to CJ.
I would say
CJ?
That voiceover Cotty. Was very on the pitch.
Watch your overtalk, guys.
Cotty, pick a name.
No, oh, Nene gets
the name.
It. Pick it.
Oh, I go again.
Yep. Yeah.
Pick it good.
Look your nose.
That was really good.
Da-da-da-da-da.
Oh, my God. Please get, like, old-timey saloon guy.
That should be a thing. If that's not a thing, can we make that a thing?
Hombre negro enojado. Black man angry.
Yes, that's
angry black man?
That's Dowdy's favorite.
And number six for me there.
Are you asking him to blackface? That's not cool.
Can we get saloon guy?
Blackpeoplemeet.com.
CJ earned a black card. I don't want him to lose it.
I just handed you a Sharpie, so if you want to go all in.
No, because when he did Chola, he didn't Sharpie his eyebrows.
He didn't use any Sharpie.
He needs a shaver, eh?
All right, CJ, give us number 6.
I gotta channel my inner John Q really fast.
What, are you gonna go to the internet to find something?
He's gotta Snapchat this.
Hold on, I gotta... My son's in the hospital. He needs a... Okay.
Oh, you went to sad moments.
He's in the hospital because you knocked him out for the diaper change.
There it is.
Hashtag knockout
angry
baby.
Black man. Oh my goodness. Okay, let's do this. Let's figure this out.
Samuel L. Jackson.
It's got to come from the chest a little
Michelle
bit.
Obama.
CJ, drink some more of that beer first.
Yeah.
Slam that.
You'll need to get drunk.
By the way, it's a fantastic Riley's Brew. It's the it's the one that gets you all fucked up.
Cougar is amazing.
Cougars always
get
you fucked up.
Sancho's pretty tight, too.
True.
That's how you want them.
Mm-hmm.
I do like a good Sancho.
Mm-kela. Okay, I'll stop.
Delicious Sancho.
Hi, puppy.
What's Sancho's bad? Okay.
See, it's
an angry black man, not. Never mind.
It's married guy because of a Sancho, okay.
Yeah. Yeah.
All right, let me get this.
You do it as an angry gay black man.
I can already see where why this band has been around for so long and only now getting somewhere. You take your time, man.
Yeah, yeah. We do whatever we want. Once
in
very
October,
right.
We released
Christine's got the talent. She throws it at you. You're like, oh, we gotta program this though.
Okay.
Whoa. Push the brakes a little bit. Let's pump these.
Pump the brakes. Will Smith's coming in.
All right, I'm going in. I'm gonna go for it. Hey. Standing out in the hot room sun can be a drag, all puns intended. But everybody should experience the depth and breadth of our community at this at least once.
Amen!
Yeah, amen.
Certainly sounds like Al Sharpton.
Hey! You said the people outside your social circle, the tourists from Park, and all those people who wouldn't mix in a million gay years.
You go, Al.
And where else are you going to see? Huh? Where else are you going to see Dax on bikes anyways?
Ooh, okay.
That was right. Good.
Oh, yeah. That was like angry Kanye through the whole thing.
No, you don't have to say angry when you say his name.
It's just Kanye.
That was like Charles Manson.
That was almost like Friday, like, I'm going to throw some hot sauce in my psychopath.
I'm looking at the internet.
Don't tell him that.
Yeah, I'm
sorry for all that racist, sexist shit I just said. Also, my bad, guys.
For
the internet's find it.
Internet says. Team Fan Band.
It just sounds like you were making a motorcycle
BLM.
Noise.
BLM.
Can
all
you right, hand me the
right, next one?
Jared, can you hand me the paper?
No.
The one that's in the middle.
Be polite,
there.
You hipster Jesus prick.
All right. So
no, I'm sorry. You were the chola.
We're in round two now, since we've gone a full round in Team
DJ
Fan Band.
DJ voice off.
2-1.
Pew, pew.
You have the button, and you still do it with your
it's
mouth.
It's more fun with that.
That's what she said.
So we're going to swap order now.
She enjoys it.
Okay. We're going to swap order now. So Team Fan Band is going to go first, and then Team Sadness, a.k.a. Kenneth, is going to go second.
Ooh, a change.
Ooh. And we're also going to mix up who goes against who. So Kenneth.
Mixed it up.
He's gonna go get JJ. Jared. So
let's go, Jared.
Because you didn't go against him last time. Jared, that's why it's different.
You're on number 7 there.
Such difference.
And Cotty, have CJ pull a term from the hat.
He's gonna pull a name. He's gonna pull. I don't know. I don't
what
have
is
music
wrong
for
with
this.
You? What the hell?
Damn it, sound guy.
May the.
All right. Comic book villain.
Aww. So you gotta do number 7.
Damn it.
You're gonna do John Travolta?
Ain't it cool?
Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
Dude.
Joanne.
What?
Well, let's go.
Did you just make a House Bunny reference?
You just make
number 7 is called Develop a Gator.
Oh, this is going
to
be great.
The sense of being able to find other homosexuals in a given area isn't inborn.
Do I even
like
go?
A sense of direction or ESP? I'm just going to skip to the last sentence because it's really long.
Like a villain.
This really hurts. Not only will it help you determine when you're a safe space with others of your kind, it will also direct you to which clerk to flirt with for your discounts.
Rachel!
Which right. flight attendant to wink at for a free tiny bottle of moose?
Death metal.
All right, here we go.
Do I even fucking raid now?
All right.
Is it, who's
no.
up?
Kenneth.
Who's up for Team Sadness?
Kenneth.
Kenneth?
Is.
All right. Pull a name.
Oh, my God. I'm
TJ,
crying.
Pull a name.
Oh, my God.
Pull my name. Pull my name.
When no one is around you.
Tell baby I love you.
You know what I don't mean?
Oh, we're old.
Okay.
Nagging girlfriend.
You're reading as Cotty.
What?
What?
Yeah. Oh, no, he didn't. Between us, you're the nagging girlfriend. I agree. Watch my
right.
long box.
It's
watch
a good thing
my
in my marriage is family therapist. Intro.
Kenneth's moment. Come on. Respect a retard.
Do it like you're the crazy pregnant one.
No, angry. Hasn't had sex in a long time.
Yeah, jealous. The crazy pregnant
one. No, that's just
nuts
me.
And meth.
If we're reading is me.
No, I'm talking about you. No, go ahead.
Hang on. Getting into my mind.
Oh, Jesus Christ. You're going to be a diva now, too?
Isn't
I
that
mean,
what,
it worked.
Won't that work?
It takes a little longer. I think I'm going to talk in this voice.
You should.
I think you should use that at your shows.
He won't have a voice
I'm
tomorrow.
I'm going to talk dirty to my fiance like this.
You're fake just because you can talk in the voice.
Patrick Bateman.
The Whisper Song by Ying Yang Twins.
Oh, God.
They're talking off mic.
Kenneth, go!
Kenneth, go.
I can't even read.
Yeah, you can.
I know you can't read, but just do it anyways.
What the hell is going on over there?
Don't
it's
worry
not
about
there.
It. Kenneth,
shut
read.
Up! God damn it! You're killing me, man.
Number 8, appreciate camp. Like that camp you went to with that bitch last summer. It's everything from Showgirls, which I caught you watching last night. You gonna watch that instead of me tonight? Or Mommy Dearest, you call her Mommy, don't you? All the fucking time. To John Waters. Yes, before hipsters, I can't even read the rest of this.
Yeah, you can.
You were doing so well.
Okay. Oh, Cotty, hold on, Cotty. If you could do better, I would
we
love to hear nagging girls.
Okay, okay.
Thank you.
I'm having a tough time with this round.
Give it to Chris
because the villain was Christian Bale.
I'm Batman.
Right.
By the way,
where is she?
By the way, try that during sex and see how that works with your girl.
Why don't you?
I'm gonna fuck you right now.
Nope.
No, that's
I
then,
unzip
no.
my pants.
I can't read this.
Only if you have a Batman mask on the entire time.
And we have a winner. It is Team Fan Band.
There was no way I was gonna win that.
Yes!
All right, come on, Team Sadness.
Come
step
on.
Up. Do
your
something.
Name is Sadness.
Yeah, come on.
Do we have Nene? Nene up on
yeah,
top?
Right here.
Right now, we have CJ Me. Versus Nene. So CJ Nene. Is up.
CJ Nene. All right, hand it over.
Hand that over. He's reading number 9. All right,
JJ.
Number 9.
Okay, you gotta let it go.
You
man.
Know, if your voice
by the way,
is
the
gone
internet,
by the end of the
hold
show.
Hold on, let me just say the internet just popped in. That sounds more like Batman and not so much a villain. Thank you, Samuel.
Not at all villain.
Meh. You know what Batman says, you live long enough. You die a hero, you live long enough to see yourself
Harvey
become the
Dent
villain.
Harvey Dent said that, damn it.
Oh, whatever. I almost thought
he
said
like I fucking
he
care.
Said it
focus
again
universe.
At the
learn
end.
Your
shit. Batman repeats it at the end, right before, right after he throws Harvey Dent off the ledge, before he tries to kill Gordon's son. Spoiler alert.
Awesome. So you didn't get laid till 25. Next read.
23, actually.
Yeah. Oh.
But he's like 24, so that's okay.
Yeah.
He's still better than Kenneth.
She's 22, actually.
Yeah.
It's the fucking greatest year of his life.
Setting himself
must
up.
Must be nice.
That is an admirable
must
trait,
be,
by the way.
Must be
God damn
fucking
it, Jared,
nice.
What do I have to do this voice in?
CJ, you will be talking
in
the voice
shit.
Of Westboro Baptist minister.
Why is everyone getting good voices?
You did
and I'm
really
getting
good.
Shit.
Black,
I'm
like,
getting
angry
shit.
Mexican.
You are shit.
Angry black person. So there you go.
The
focus.
Black angry Mexican.
Here we go.
My
CJ, bad. Give it to us.
I'm
all
real
right,
drunk.
Westboro. Man, I'm wildly different headspace here. Okay.
Just hate everyone.
Yeah. Apparently, shit.
Not just white people.
But he sounds like he would never.
You love Jesus, but he's a Jew.
Yeah.
Jesus right? loves you.
Don't tell them that. Wait a second.
He won't be able to save your souls if you're gay.
And there's the fact that you hate right there.
Yeah, yeah.
There you go.
I didn't
why is
say
he a better
sound boy?
Fucking Pete.
Pete, okay. Could you stop impersonating that might win Westboro
Pete,
Baptist
can you not?
Minister?
That might win you. Hashtag.
Read fucking, it.
Fucking
here we go. AIDS nearly wiped out a generation of gay men. Many gay men coming out of AIDS already know this intellectually.
Oh, shit.
But they had no clue about the emotional cost of losing friends and slowly but surely the disease of being forced to live with the diagnosis as death sentence. Well, the quilt is now a shrine to everyone who's going to just get that died of the gay disease. not just gay men. It is a class thing. We're going to go to the museum, and the best way to document that lies we had in the past. We all of them now be forgotten.
I think he just read that as regular Baptist minister.
Or, okay, Nene.
He got close to Boomhauer somehow.
I slipped a little Boomhauer in there.
Okay, yeah. Let's go. Let's go, Nene.
By the way, tomorrow
we need to know what
Nene
is going to
do. Nene, you got
to
take this, or we go another round.
By the way, tomorrow there's Art for AIDS support.
Oh my God! Shut up! Read the goddamn thing.
Wait, we got to tell him what voice he's got to be.
Where's the hat?
Nene.
Number 10. Number 10.
Right. Yeah, you're doing number 10, but we don't know what it is.
Still only have one winner here.
My name is Ron Burgundy.
Oh, come on.
You're writing it as a news anchor.
You will be talking as a news anchor.
Just end every sentence with a question.
And make sure not to inform America about anything.
All right, so you are reading
classic
number 10.
Misdirection.
And yes, go.
San Diego is Mexican for a whale's vagina. In our age of gay straight alliance in school and celebrities who live in our perpetual glass closet without ever making a final announcement, what am I even doing? Coming out seems it's going out of style? Why would gay people have to come when straight people don't? Someone give me a vodka.
Thank you, Dick
I'm
Hartley.
I'm sorry. That's...
Oh.
No, man. You
went... didn't go to Wally with the news?
Yeah.
It's hot. You know? Come on.
You
it's
start...
raining.
It's raining sideways.
He gonna get it.
You started with something, and then you went gay for some reason. I gotta give this... I'm
sexuality
this...
is fluid.
Give it to Craig J.
Fan band.
Team fan band for the win.
I think it's safe to say we're fucked.
Oh,
so, the MVP of that I'm going to give to CJ. You've got a minute to talk about.
Man, you're jumping really quick.
Whatever you want to talk about for the next minute. Chris, are you ready to play the music, you motherfucker?
Go!
And go.
Hi, what's up? I'm CJ. I'm in Amoret. We're playing a show.
No,
this...
don't talk about that.
Oh,
shit.
Not,
talk
not about,
about
that.
No, no plugs. No plugs. No
okay,
plugs.
Cool.
Totally free.
That's all he had.
Yeah, I have nothing better to talk about.
When did you
Me and Kevin
go?
Have the same hat. I almost wore that hat, and I'm not convinced that he didn't steal my hat, and so I'm going
to
fight him later outside for
to
the hat.
Death.
I want my fucking hat back.
You still got 30 seconds, man. Go.
So the thing about walnuts and brownies is...
Oh, my God. Christine, talk
they
about walnuts and brownies.
An ungodly thing. Why the fuck would you put walnuts in brownies? Walnuts do not belong in anything. They are Satan's nuts. Hands down. You don't want to bite into a soft brownie and get crunchy shit. Holy shit. Walnuts and brownies. Sucks a lot.
That's almost sexy
okay,
as the
I've never
voice.
Done this before, but I'm going to go
Did you ever
ahead.
Put chips in your sandwich as a kid?
Stand by. I've never done this before, but I'm going to give you guys another point. Because that walnuts, yeah, I get that. You're like, yeah. If you're eating a brownie, I don't want any fucking chunky shit, just like girls who swallow, right?
Oatmeal
brownies.
Ghirardelli
turtle.
It's like going to Disneyland.
Ghirardelli turtle
like
brownies.
Mickey, like Chuck E. Cheese. It just doesn't
matter.
All
right.
Let's do this. We're going to take a very quick break. Those are still hanging out. Sorry, Mom. And we're going to come back.
Wait, this
Kenneth.
Is live?
Yes.
Out 2 hours ago.
No editing.
And Miss Debbie, it was easy.
We're going to come back. Way. We got the Tardies from Kenneth. That's his moment to try to sound good. It's not going to sound good. And we'll be right back. This is your Daddy Podcast here on Longbox.fm.
Fake break. Quick break.
I'm gonna go call an
apartment. You got people that have weird stuff.
Friends.
Sorry, guys. No. Actually, don't go anywhere.
Whatever you guys got to do, go quick.
Very quick break.
Quick.
What do you need?
Beer.
You have like, Pale. You have like 30 seconds.
Hey, CJ, could I have a pineapple mango too, please? Gracias.
You're the best.
Faster.
Why aren't you back?
Not fast enough.
Damn. I would like to personally...
You're here, why?
Pineapple mango.
Fuck it, I'm gonna I have so many friends in the LGBT community. I even got invited to the Transgender Remembrance on October 12th and a fundraiser next weekend. I'm like, uh-oh.
We performed for a fundraiser show.
They're going to be mad at me.
I would have accepted their will or be blood.
And then my favorite...
There will be no blood.
My favorite diva is Lil Ani. I already have a diva, and she's a local.
Hey, make me sound like the 1975. Okay. Dude, I have tickets to go see them up in Oakland.
Oh, shit.
Yeah. I got a password for an early pre-sale.
Nice.
So, yeah.
Really when is that?
I can't remember right now because I'm drunk, but October something, 20th?
Ish?
Yeah, 20-ish. I took that tickets to the Strombellas and Cold War Kids and Tegan and Sarah. I was going to go to churches, but that falls between two of my concerts, so I couldn't go.
We're doing like concert gauntlet for the past couple weeks. Like, we did Days of Chaos, then we just went up and saw a brand new Modest Mouse in Portland the other night.
Yeah,
awesome. And then we're doing Warped
this is part of the weekend.
Yeah. And then we're doing Blink when they come back through.
Yeah, I'll be here on October 12th, right?
Okay, good.
I over the weekends just for tickets for to buy tickets for concerts.
My cougar had a little free.
that's some head.
You're doing it right, okay?
The Dirty Dowdy Podcast. Online. On Facebook. Just hit up our Facebook page for all things Dirty Dowdy. That's facebook.com/TheDirtyDowdyPodcast.
It's Dirty Dowdy Podcast back here in the Longbox.FM studios with flailing, wacky, armling, wailing man. Also known as my penis. And that guy over there.
These are my Kermit arms.
And,
Woo! Those are those also Dowdy arms.
Stop it.
Nope. Also nope. That's not a thing.
I love it.
Nope.
I'm sorry. Finish your announcement.
Can we have more of that?
This is the time that we give love back to our... God damn it! To our Make-A-Wish candidate for tonight. How do you stay with him, Christine? You had to punch him in the face, right?
We have a divorce button. I shit you not.
Oh my God, can I show him the divorce button?
It's yeah, so there's funny. Also an undivorced button when I redeem myself.
Do you fucking hate this guy right here
so
when
it's
I
always,
hate this guy?
So it's always you redeeming yourself? Well, so that, far I haven't let him redeem himself.
No.
What's the divorce button?
She said some dumb shit in a group text once, and I was
there's
like...
some big fucking problems.
So she said something, and I was like... All I sent in response was this picture of this divorce button that I thought was very funny and tasteful.
Oh, it's like the
easy
staples,
button.
The easy button.
Staples, if only it was that button. Easy.
But if there was a sound bite, it'd be like...
You a stupid how. You a stupid
oh, my God.
You a stupid how. You a stupid how.
Tila's never coming here.
That song.
That's not Tila. How dare you?
Women back 20 years.
How dare you offend Tila with the scratch?
No. Wait, she Tila Tequila. Herself.
Have you guys seen her Twitter?
No. Have you seen her?
I love it.
That's she is insane.
I read that to
She's
my son
like
every
Illuminati
night.
Illuminati in space. Like if Illuminati's on Earth, I get it. That's real. But in space, Illuminati. That's where she lost me a little bit.
This Riley's is really good, by the way.
Absolutely. By the way, brought to you by Riley's Brewing.
Thanks, Riley's.
Kenneth, it's
you guys didn't want
this
W Brewing?
This podcast was brought to you by Riley's Brewing.
Okay, radio.
Drink a beer or
my
something.
God,
thanks.
I hate you.
Christine, where is it conveniently located?
Place. This is going to be the street.
This is going to be Christine's Dirty Christine podcast.
TCP.
Get out of your studio.
All right,
ooh,
it is
dirty
time.
Christine,
it
I
is time.
I like that shit.
I like that.
For the you make- can leave.
The make-a-wish moment of the night.
Fuck the sound guy.
Make sure you put the image up there.
No, thank you.
Oh, yeah, my bad.
Oh, I'm
yeah.
fucking
it's the make-a-wish moment
too
of the
much,
night.
Too much, man.
It's time for the Tardies. It's Kenneth.
Oh,
how do you do?
Lord. It took a lot to get that picture from Kenneth's mom.
Hey, who got in my phone?
Who well, hacked the NRA?
That was...
So we have the Tardies tonight. And of course, we have a lot of hashtags tonight. A lot of fucking hashtags. We, of course, have DDP Live and Make Fresno Better, which would be better without us, let's believe it. We have Warm Piz, No Rugrats, Cold Piz, If Your Dad, Phrasing, Fucking Pete. Yeah, fuck you, Pete. Team Steel Beam versus Team Jet Fuel. Team, oh yeah! Team Thug Life Jared and Team Chayate. But I believe the winners, thank you, Riley's, because without you tonight probably wouldn't have gone this way. Nope. We, of course, have the worst joke of the night, and I actually give that to Kevin, even though he isn't here, but eh, whatever, fuck it. Righteous for his Poke Go. Yeah, Raichu. Yeah. Yeah, exactly. It's
damn it, why
horrible.
Wasn't I here for that?
Dude, you missed
because
it.
Because you work.
I have a job. I'm a pussy.
Unless you're Dowdy, in which case he's just fucking unemployed. We have best quote of the night, and there were a couple of contenders. We had Kevin with mufflers are hella hot. And Christine with jet fuel doesn't melt steel beams. But the winner of the night goes to Alex was, you're saying you liked dick before it was cool? Who also wins for the best moment of the night, DJ Voice Off. I would have given it to Kevin, but fuck him, he's not here. Alex, you win it for him, who is also Kevin, by the way. We have a Most Horrible Human Award. Which
no curtain pull.
We have a Most Horrible Human Award, and I gave that, I actually changed the name of that just now, to Fuck Dowdy Award. We have a winner of the Fuck Dowdy Award, and that goes to Dowdy, just because he's a flaming asshole. Thank you, and fuck you.
Hold
and
on. Of all the shit I give you, flaming asshole is the best you can come back with?
I've given
not
you plenty.
A ginger.
I've given you plenty of shit tonight.
Well,
including
yeah.
your flailing inflatable dick joke, yeah. But anyway, we have Clam Joke Awards tonight. We had for the puh story. There were a couple of contenders here, robbing the grave from Kevin, biting the head from Dowdy, but fuck Dowdy. I gave it to Christine for oh police.
Boom.
And of course, we have an MVP of the night. And, you know, there were so many fucking awards to
play
hand
with
out.
The music.
I just gave
play
it-
with the music. Listen to Christine. She knows.
Yeah, music, bro.
I'm sorry, but it's been a long time since we've gotten this far in the song.
Says that to every girl.
That many talented people.
Sorry,
here.
I'm just not used to lasting this long.
Yeah, exactly.
It's I gave
just
it
got
to,
a 10-second set.
I gave MVP of the night to Jared for his Batman villain interpretation. And because fuck Dowdy.
You're a dick, man.
All right, so Jared, you've got a minute on the mic.
I'm a bigger dick than you.
To talk about whatever the fuck you want to talk about that's not your plug.
All right, Jared, are you ready for this? A true minute, ready, set, go.
So this one time I went into the bathroom at Edwards and I was really, really drunk and I tried to pee in the urinal and I ended up leaning over too far to the right and I just was like leaning onto the barrier and I ended up peeing on this dude's shoes and he was in a stall so like he was like mid poop.
Did you go up and over or
he was,
under?
No. He was mid poop. I went under. It like
that was quite a lot of accuracy.
It was like one of those like it's on the bowl. It's on the bowl. Oh, it's on the wall. It's on the stall wall. It's on his shoes. And like all I heard was, "What the fuck, man?" And I couldn't do anything. I was laughing so hard. I just ran out of the bathroom. And that's my
anyways, that's how Jared met his husband.
Congratulations.
They're getting married in May 2017. Read about it.
Read about it.
Read about it.
Okay. Yeah. Well, next week we got, I don't know who the fuck is coming on.
Mercury and, Bullet and Flight 409.
We need to do, you guys, yeah, oh, that's right. You guys have a show coming.
Oh, shit.
Tell us about it.
Yes. CJ, you were so right to talk about it earlier.
I know, and then I forgot everything once I knew I didn't have
to
do that.
Okay, cool. August 11th, Frank's Place. Read about it. What?
And also you get them standing on stage looking just like the screen right now.
Yes,
dude, very cash.
I'm going to stand exactly like
No. Christine, I gotta explain. The position you have, like the hand up, like I was just teasing my hair.
It's you don't know.
And why is every guy in the background pissed off?
Because we didn't want to take the fucking photo. That's why. That's actually taken at Tioga Sequoia. I said a different. I'm sorry. Let's make up a brewery, like a terrible brewery. We were playing at W Brewing.
No, it's okay. We're friends.
So
this is a true story.
Cool with that.
Okay. We were like supposed to play like 1 minute after that photo was taken, and Christine was hellbent on taking new band promos, and I was like, we can do this any other time. Let's not do it. And so that's why we look super pissed off.
And that's was why that I got promos done and he never has.
Oddly, though, one of those guys in the background looked a little gay.
Which Josh?
One? Josh?
He's the worst.
Jared?
I don't know.
The guy husband? On the left, right?
The guy with the long hair?
I can't allow this to happen. Gotti, you don't show up all night long and you talk now. The only way you can say that is if you say that again in a British accent.
Not going to do that.
That was god awful. I'm sorry.
I've heard a lot of British accents in my day, but like that was one of the least. That was just a bloody awful.
It was rubbish, truly.
Because yeah, Dowdy doesn't know what he's talking about.
Man, all of these.
Yo, a bunch of fucking twats.
All of these accents.
That sounds horrible.
It's like a wee bit Irish there.
It was like, I don't know.
Fucking Paul Rudd.
And with that, this is Dowdy saying for everyone.
Step into base, man. Everyone. Just a really bad accent.
This is my moment to shut the show down.
Just shut it down.
This is Dowdy saying for everyone in the room. Go see the show. Oh, by the way, if you want to win tickets, just call me up right now.
492-0450.
Also,
I need a date for Friday's concert.
Jesus Christ, I hate everyone.
8673-09.
That was an amazing clusterfuck.
It was like it was horribly planned.
Kyle and Nancy.
I think he's got a few of those moments
right now for her birthday.
Jesus Christ.
We don't have to drink.
Hi, you won. Goodbye.
Pinky, you're a winner.
Who did?
You won
tickets.
Oh, suck
my dick. You won.
High
tickets. We'll talk to you tomorrow.
Is it Kyle or Jen?
Yeah, you win.
It's Kyle, isn't it?
I need more. Shut up.
Hi, Kyle.
Hey, we got new pictures.
Like,
shut up.
Hey, Mike Miller with at least one ticket over here.
Yeah. Oh, my God, Jared, you're gone.
Was it Kyle or Jen?
So you missed the picture.
I ran.
Woo! Making it red.
Who was it?
Alright, let me get a picture of everyone.
Oh,
that's right.
With who?
I was like, Alice, what the fuck? Oh, no, never mind.
Wrong Kevin.
Who's gonna wear the hat?
JJ.
1, 2, 3,
JJ's gone. Alright, line up. Let's get a picture.
I would say Pete has a smart
head. Do we have bathroom shit going on?
No,
he
left.
No, Jared left.
Jared left.
He does that shit.
Wife duties.
Word.
Fiance duties, right?
Yeah, yeah, I hear you. My wife is like blowing my phone up, like, when are you coming home? I need to pull laundry, blah, 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 blah.
Like, so, like, is this actually why being in a band together works?
Why
aren't
you home?
Oh, I know.
Because
that's why
you're
right here next to me.
You know what? With that hat, you were
so Renee, Cotty, picture, what? Now.
Yeah, that
go.
Hat works.
I'm going to go ahead.
I didn't mean Kid Rock, but. No,
I was no, even I don't on go the show. Go
it's Little Kid Rock.
But you're here, so get over here.
Lil Kid Rock?
Like the hat.
Lil Rock?
Lil Rock. Picture time!
Didn't drink it in bullshit.
It's super your time.
I wasn't really last on the call show, for but...
I know, it's crazy. Cody's going to show up.
What do you drink?
But yeah, I like
Oh, Kenneth. Can we do like the clothes for a popular penis?
All right, guys, here we go.
I have to figure out a, like...
All right, try to be cute or whatever the fuck.
I like how everybody's
standing
straight.
I can't do
that.
You know, I'm taking random pictures and I'm just going to post the ones that make you look the worst.
Stop moving! I don't want to touch your ass.
For
it's
one
okay, good, kid, it's fine.
For one CJ? Good picture, can I get a? Can I get the look of Dowdy in a booth at New Rock?
This, hold up.
Oh wait!
I may take that. Oh no! Stay out of sound equipment.
All right, we're good. Yes.